from the Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach Studio.
We want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
This is 97.9 WRMF Palm Beach.
Well, we asked a question on our Instagram and our Facebook page. What would you say is one of the most played out songs of all time? Jaybird thinks it's A Little Journey.
Don't stop believing.
I heard it three times the other day.
Yeah.
Once in the car from two different stations, and then once from one of my neighbor's backyards.
Oh, it does. Yeah.
It's pumping out.
It plays all the time and everywhere. Song that I love, but it did get kind of played when it went viral. I mentioned it a second ago. Was that Fleetwood Mac "Dreams" that was in that viral video of the guy longboarding?
It's kind of in a dentist's office today.
It is a very dentist's office-y kind of song. Yeah, without a doubt. Okay. Yeah, just a couple of the songs that people think are played.
Bum, bum, bum. Sweet.
Oh.
I just love hating it. I like talking about the hatred, Kevin.
Yeah, I mean, man, they play it at sporting events now. People always sing along to it.
Sweet Caroline. Bam, bam, bam. The time never seems so good.
Yeah.
So good.
I know. It's kind of rough, isn't it?
Sometimes those songs that where you have to add in the extra lyrics that everyone knows, but they weren't in the original song. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Sometimes. No,
where you got to do some of the work.
I like it. Don't get me wrong.
Okay. All right. You're kind of a fan of it.
How do you feel about Brown Eyed Girl? I used to love it, but now I'm just like, oh, not again.
I'm with you. A brown eyed girl. And you, my brown eyed girl.
It's one of those songs when you start playing out at the bars, you have to play that song. It's like the Joker.
People just demand it.
They demand it, Kevin.
Okay. I don't want to be disrespectful, but can I get an amen?
Wasting away again in
Margaritaville. Come on now. Come on now.
I almost said it, and I'm glad you did.
Somebody had to say it. We couldn't go through this whole thing and not say it. I mean, RIP, JB, but, you know, come on, man.
We love the man.
Yeah. You just hear it a
You do. I mean, and I think Florida more than any other place in the world, too. So you're kind of in it.
Yeah, absolutely. Another song I probably could do without for a while.
I started singing bye-bye, Miss American Pie. Drove my Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry. Them good old boys were drinking whiskey and rye and singing, this'll be the day that I die.
Uh-huh.
It's... people do for karaoke. It's about 7 minutes long. And I remember there was this couple who he did that song, the whole thing, and then his wife got up. That was right after him and did Me and Bobby McGee, which is another.
Oh, man, another play tune.
Long.
Yes. Doesn't end.
Wow. Mike Hoggs.
There's like 15 minutes of this couple.
Could you say this song is a bit played out?
Buddy, you're a boy, make a big noise. Playing in the street, gonna be a big man someday. You got mud on your face, you big disgrace. Kicking your can all over the place. Singing, we will.
It is, but I still love it.
Okay, you're still okay with that
one? I'm not, yeah, I can still get down. They had Queen, We Are the Champions, playing in the lobby the other day.
Yeah.
And I'm like, gosh, man, this thing hits so hard. It's a great song.
How do you feel about this song? Beloved, but is it played?
I had the single of this, and I had a big... when I saw The Bodyguard, I had a huge crush on Whitney Houston.
Oh, you did? Okay.
And he's coming off a big run where he just watched a lot of Whitney Houston videos.
I just came off. I'm still on that run. I love Whitney Houston. Me and Danny's listened to her a lot together.
All right, simmer down. You don't have to get pissed.
What about this one? This song played?
Here I go again on my own.
It's in a car commercial right now, or I think it's a insurance commercial, car insurance commercial.
I don't think it's played.
Maybe motorcycle insurance.
I
you
like
don't think
that.
That's played?
I like that.
Okay.
I mean, it's not my favorite song. I wouldn't say played.
Okay. Got hit on the radio a lot. What I thought was kind of interesting, I was doing a little bit of a deeper dive on some songs that have really been played a ton
I got
on
one.
The radio.
Don't Speak by No Doubt. Don't Speak is always on, still on the radio.
Yeah, they got played a lot. That was the most played song, whatever year that was, 96, I think it was.
I still like that one, though.
Okay.
Oh.
Okay. There were a few. I was just looking on at songs based on radio play. This song has been played over 5 million times on the radio. It must have been. I can't still feel it, though. I don't know.
I'm okay with that.
You know, the ones that really stood out to me when you're looking at radio plays, how many plays that they've gotten just on the radio, there are some songs that are newer that have as many plays as older songs that have been around 20 years longer than them. Some of the ones that are on this list with 5 million radio plays. Uptown Funk, Mark Ronson, Bruno Mars has got 5 million plays. Also, 5 million plays on the radio.
I'm in love with your body. I'm in love with your body.
That is a lot. Other songs, 5 million plays. This probably will not surprise you too much because I feel like I still hear this song all the time. Hey, Soul Sister by Train.
Why does that? That is weird. There's a lot of songs that are in that genre that are just as good, if not better. And that gets so much shine. Why?
Yeah, I don't know. It just is a highly played song. Kind of crazy. And speaking of crazy, this song has been played 4 million times.
I was on a Publix yesterday.
Oh, was it?
Okay. And I was walking down the aisle, and I was just noticing other people kind of grooving like I was.
Yeah.
KVJ Replay on 97.9 WRMF.
Rosalitas! Rosalitas!
Spice up your life with the best, most authentic Tex-Mex grill in Palm Beach at Rosalitas in Lantana. They welcome you to the award-winning restaurant with only the finest meats, poultry, and fish dishes. A family-run restaurant since 1994. The minute you walk in the door of Rosalitas, you'll smell the aroma of delicious fajitas, burritos, or enchiladas made fresh to order. Their friendly staff is always ready to serve you with your favorite Tex-Mex dish, such as carne asada, fish tacos, baby back ribs, or Santa Fe salad, spinach, and chicken enchiladas. Or you can always go the lighter side with a tortilla soup and a taco salad. Rosalitas is open daily, starting with happy hour from 11 till 7, lunch and dinner. And there's always something fun going on at Rosalitas with karaoke on Tuesdays and Fridays and live music on Saturdays. What are you waiting for? Come and spice up your life. 561-964-5747 on the corner of Lantana and Congress.
Come and spice up your life at Rosalitas. Rosalitas.
I'm Mark Anajar.
I'm Glenn Levine.
I'm Ellie Anajar.
Together, we're Anajar and Levine.
If you've been hurt in a car crash, we'll fight to get you the maximum compensation you deserve.
Call Anajar and Levine for your free consultation. 1-800-747-FREE.
In office, West Palm Beach.
As a radio stuntman, I do all the extreme stuff in your favorite commercials. But the new Times the Cash scratch-offs are a new level of action-packed. A thrilling multiplier feature, over 15 million prizes that multiply the winnings, and bonus play. They're the most extreme. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to jump this pit of hungry gates for no reason. New Times the Cash scratch-offs from the Florida Lottery. Must be 18 or older to play. Play responsibly.
Pizza's here.
Oh, great. I'd love some, but I'm worried about my stomach issues.
If you're worried about having diarrhea, gas, bloating, stomach pain, or loose, oily stools, it may not just be stomach issues. It could be a condition called exocrine pancreatic insufficiency, or EPI. With EPI, the pancreas doesn't release enough enzymes to break down food, but EPI is manageable. Use the symptom checker on identifyepi.com and talk to your doctor. That's identifyepi.com. Sponsored by AbbVie.
Hi, I'm Jade, and the little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A sausage, egg, and cheese biscuit is the savoriness of the sausage, the fluffiness of the egg, and the butteriness of the biscuit. It's amazing. The perfect start to my day.
Hi, everyone. It's Justin. A little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A sausage, egg, and cheese biscuit is the fluffy egg, the melted cheese, and the sizzling sausage. It's the start to your morning that you didn't know you need.
Order a sausage, egg, and cheese biscuit and Simply Orange Juice on the Chick-fil-A app. Real guests paid for their testimonials.
It is so important that you stay up with the maintenance of your AC. Do what I do. I'm in the cooling club and I get regular service and maintenance of my system courtesy of Cooling Advisors. They come out on a regular basis. They check the system. They do the tune-ups. They do the work. They do the line cleaning. They make sure that my system is functioning at its top peak level, saving me on energy costs. Yeah, that can save you like up to 30% a year. On energy cost just by keeping up with the maintenance of your system. And when you keep up with your system, you get a longer life out of it, protecting your investment. I love the Cooling Club. You should call about it too. Go online, coolingadvisors.com. Over 70 years of experience, family owned and operated. They're not some big corporation from out of town. It's local guys, local families running this company, and they care about their reputation, so they get customer service right. Go to coolingadvisors.com.
Here at Massey, we've seen the damage termites can cause. That's why we've protected homes from termite damage for almost 100 years. Our termite protection program doesn't just protect your home from termites, it gives you peace of mind. That's why our termite protection guarantee covers your home and all the things in it. When we protect against termites, we protect families. Schedule your free inspection today at MasseyServices.com. Massey Services. Expect more and get it.
Z-O-O-M-T-A-N. I was tan last summer, now I'm pale again. I need a little bit of help to be ready for the beach. Zoom Tan puts some within my reach. Brown as a biscuit for $9.99. ZoomTan.com for a limited time.
Zoom Tan, $9.99. Zoom Tan.
All copper tans are now Zoom tans. Go to ZoomTan.com/radio for $9.99 offer.
Ew, gotta get rid of this old Backstreet Boys t-shirt.
Tell me why.
Because it stinks, boys.
Tell me why.
I've washed it so many times, but the odor won't come out.
Tell me why.
No, you tell me why I can't get rid of this odor.
Have you tried Downy Rinse and Refresh? It doesn't just cover up odors. It helps remove them.
Wow, it worked, guys.
Yeah.
Downy Rinse and Refresh removes more odor in one wash than the leading value detergent in three washes. Find it wherever you buy laundry products.
Hey, honey, I have a great idea for summer vacation. Let's go to Chicago. We can take the kids to the aquarium, the Navy Pier, and maybe even a baseball game. We can eat deep dish pizzas and Chicago-style hot dogs.
That's a great idea, and the kids will love it, but only if we fly from PBI.
Chicago, here we come.
Let's book our flight today.
Already on it.
Palm Beach International Airport, South Florida's award-winning and favorite airport. Now flying direct to Chicago. Visit PBIA.org for more info.
Now back to more of the KVJ replay. Only on 97.9 WRMF.
When you went clubbing, where did you go? Do you remember your favorite clubs from back in the day, Virginia?
Oh, yeah. I used to hit Bourbon Street.
Okay.
As a young girl with a fake ID, I was skipping down Bourbon Street.
Yeah?
It was fun.
What was the name of the club that stands out to you?
I mean, we used to go to Bourbon Cowboy.
Okay.
We used to go to Johnny Mac's. We used to go to Maggie May's. We used to go to the Gold Mine. Oh, my gosh. The Gold Mine was so dirty. It was just...
The Gold Mine, the filthy spot.
It was scuzzy.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Bert, what about you? What was your favorite club from back in the day?
Only talking about flirts.
Okay.
Chase skirts at flirts.
You could take it to second base flirts.
People would hook up in flirts. That was where you go to get a little naughty. Well, you had a bunch of just people who were very young, just kind of learning how to drink, and then they're just getting in there and just... People would jump in the cage, and then things would happen in the cage. We're talking carnal things.
Everybody was watching?
Oh, yeah. That's what made it exciting.
Let me see some of the top answers that we got. Bringing it down by city in West Palm Beach. Gemma said, last weekend in Club Safari.
Club Safari. I can't tell you how many times me and my friends got kicked out of that place.
Okay. Heather, she would go hang out at Liquid. You remember that down on Clematis Street?
Yes, yeah. I do.
You remember Bar?
Yeah. And the other one,
I think it was on Olive in downtown West Palm for a little bit. Yeah, and then Dax off Clematis, you said.
The one I would, it wasn't a club, but it was a bar. Although there would be some dancing there. It was at Gatsby's off of Village. Man, yeah. that place used to be jumping.
Yeah. I always hear people talking about Christine's in Jupiter. Old school people always talk about Christine's.
Old school, I do know about Christine's.
Panda talks about it.
Oh, yeah. I used to run these waters. And these shores with a panda. I'm not sure what that meant.
What?
Kathy said respectable in Palm Beach back in the 90s was where I would go clubbing in the day.
It's still there, though.
Remember when E.R. Bradley's was on Palm Beach?
Yes.
It wasn't downtown. It was on Palm Beach Island. Because we would go there and dance on the bar and get kicked out.
That's right. You ever heard of the Bowery? Sounds familiar. Where was the Bowery? That's what Butch said. He said that was where he would go clubbing.
That's
back
in New York.
Oh, okay.
The Bowery's in New York City.
Aha.
I brought up this place yesterday.
Limelight.
On the podcast, and no one knew what I was talking about. Banana Max in Jupiter. Does anybody remember that listening right now? Banana Max in Jupiter.
I think I heard of that.
Or am I making that up?
The Banana Boat?
No, Banana Max. The Max.
That does sound familiar, actually. I think I've heard that before.
But is that from Saved by the Bell? Am I getting sitcoms and...
The Peach Pit.
Yes.
Yeah.
I used to always party at the Peach Pit. Oh, wait a minute.
No, I didn't.
I know.
I just watched the show.
I'm getting you confused.
That happens.
Nicole was hanging out at Club Boca and Boca Raton back in the day.
I remember Club Boca, and I remember the Bay Club. That was, I thought, down in Boca or down in Broward County, but it was jumping back in the 90s.
Yeah, a lot of the places in Lauderdale. Dara said Voodoo Lounge is where she was clubbing back in the day. Baja Beach Club is where Sheila was going. There was also Cafe Iguana.
Yes.
At Beach Place.
I remember that.
Okay.
Remember
that? Yeah. Banana Max. It used to be where Harborside is now.
I got it right.
My friend is texting me.
Boom. I just like when you just like when you're not crazy.
Banana Max. That's where people got busted for doing a bunch of cocaine.
Oh, Kevin. We're talking,
imagine that.
We're
huh?
talking 80s cocaine. The
imagine
good stuff.
Imagine that.
The purest form.
Uh-huh. You see some other places. Debbie loved every place on the strip in Lauderdale. Confetti, La Bear, Baja Beach, Button South, Bogart's, Penrod's, Club 1235. Tressie was going to Reunion Room, Squeeze, and Rosebud's. Rachel of the Edge in Lauderdale. Trish said Atlantis on Fort Lauderdale Beach. I think I remember that from back in the day. I think that's maybe they were tossing the napkins. Nicole said America's Backyard. That place is still thriving. She went to Automatic Slims is another spot she went to. Do you remember Passions, the nightclub at the old Hard Rock? That's where Mark used to hang out.
Passions,
yeah.
I remember the soap opera.
Okay, no, I went there one time. I remember that. Eve said Christopher's in September's in Fort Lauderdale is where she was clubbing back in the day. And then some of the old Miami clubs, it's still around. Nicole, she remembers going to Nikki Beach. Chelsea went to 90 Degrees. Freddie was at the Kitchen. Let me see. We got Nicole who would go to Glam Slam. And then Audra, Live in Miami. Live has been open forever.
Yeah, it has.
Like, when has it not been open?
People saying Dr. Feelgood's.
Yeah, down in West Palm Beach on Clematis Street.
Now it's Pawn Shop.
Okay. Some of the other places. Charlotte went to Casablanca and Stewart, Sips in Port St. Lucie, and Shuckers.
Oh, what was the one they used to always send me when we were at our old station? Wild Coyote. It was like 9 different bars within, I think, a 3-month span.
They kept changing the name of it.
It was a lot, yeah. That Wild happens. Coyote.
Got a shout out for Off the Hookah. That was downtown West Palm Beach for a long time. The Chili Pepper. That might have been Lauderdale. Yeah, a lot of good stuff. That we're getting there. Ibiza. Yeah, that was a big one as well.
Spanky's.
Where was Spanky's?
So Spanky's was big on Clematis for the longest time, right by the train tracks. You know when you're down Clematis and the tracks cross over and you have to wait?
Okay.
It was right there.
Oh,
and
yeah, I do remember that. Yeah.
Very popular.
I used to go there a lot. Yeah, now it's just like a dog park.
Yeah, then I thought they had another Spanky's in Jupiter.
Okay.
Back in the early 2000s.
I do remember that. Shout out for Casanova's and Hialeah. Brio Beach Club and Club Moscow. A lot of people were saying that as well.
Club Moscow, was that off North Lake Boulevard? And was that in Gardens or Lake Park?
A lot of people name dropped it.
I remember that place.
Club Moscow?
That was too young for me. My brother would go there.
Yeah.
If it's the right place, I'm thinking.
Okay, Cruzan Liquor Stand getting that shout out as well. So lots of cool places.
Something's got a hold on me lately, though I don't know myself anymore. Feels like the walls are all closing in and the devil's knocking at my door. Whoa, out of my mind, how many times did I tell you I'm no good at being alone? Yeah, it's taking a toll on me. Trying my best to keep from tearing the skin off my bones. Don't you know? Feel like a bad habit. Bad habits, hard to break when I'm with you. Yeah, I know I can do it on my own, but I want that real full moon, bright magic, and it takes two. Problematic. Problem is when I'm with you, I'm an addict, and I need some relief. My skin and your teeth, can't see the forest through the trees, got me down on my knees.
At any age, I find all these things to be really good pieces of advice. So if you're young, good news, you're going to get these now. If you're older, it's kind of a checklist to say, okay, am I doing this? What advice would you give to your younger self? But everything in this is a really solid nugget.
Don't go to business school, bird. None of the credits are going to transfer and you're going to end up just kind of peeing that money away.
Bird's got his own list. Number one on the list, be more confident. Confidence is very important. You accomplish more things when you are confident. Believe in yourself.
But that's easier said than done.
It is.
What does someone have to do to apply that and really make that work in their life?
I think the reason why we do it better as we get older is we gain a little bit more confidence in ourselves because we're a little bit more self-aware. We start to understand our strengths and our weaknesses, and we realize that everybody has them. And you're not going to be good at absolutely everything, but if you can figure out what it is you are good at, carry some confidence around, because I believe every person was given their own set of gifts and skills that they can do, and you can do something uniquely better than about anybody else on planet Earth.
And it's not something you can just pluck off a tree sometimes. You have to work at that stuff for some people, you know?
I think that's why it's typically a trait you see later on in life, because it does take a lot of trial and error to get yourself there.
But there's good and bad. Like you said, there's qualities within you that are good, and there's qualities in you that you wish that you didn't, you know, have. Focus on those good ones and develop those good ones, and maybe don't, you know, beat yourself up about the bad ones.
Well, I think you gotta be self-aware too, knowing the hand you've been dealt with, and then using it at the best of your ability and really making it work for you.
Another piece of advice, try not to care what other people think, and that's another easier said than done, but the one thing I would at least tell you to try doing is look at the people that don't really matter in your life, and why would you care? People on social media, people that you don't like anyway, people that you know are nasty and are there to cut you down. if you can start with them and saying, I should not care at all what they think.
Yeah, if they're yucky and you wouldn't even go out to dinner with them, what do you care if their opinion of you is?
It is a good lesson to learn as a kid, almost kind of like flossing your teeth. You just know it's the way of the world.
Right.
You got to floss your teeth, if not your teeth fall out. When you go out into the world, you know there's going to be cavity people. You know what I mean? They're going to
yes.
gnaw you.
Mm-hmm. Don't let opportunities pass you by. That's really, to me, a lot of what life is. And you think about where you are, whatever you've done, if you're a little bit older and you consider yourself to be successful, there is likely an opportunity that came your way that you did not pass up, that you took advantage of. And that's why you are where you are. And so that's a lesson to a younger you, is don't let those opportunities pass you by thinking that the world is going to be full of them. Because sometimes, as Eminem says, you only get one shot.
Damn.
Mm-hmm.
Mom spaghetti.
Look after your physical health. Don't wait till it's too late in life.
When is it too late, Virginia? Can you reverse this thing?
You can, but they said it's easier to start good habits when you're younger than if you get to be 40 or 50 years old and all of a sudden you're like, well, I'm going to get healthy. And then it's just really hard because you ever heard that old dog, new tricks? Kind of hard to turn around. What other advice would you give to your younger self? Don't waste time with negative people. Very true. Be mindful. Does somebody always have negative things to say about somebody? It's not necessarily somebody you need to be spending your time with. Learn from your mistakes so you don't repeat them.
Protect your skin. You live in South Florida. Put something on to protect it. Take it from Crowfish Carla over here. I'm telling
you. Crowfish.
What are they called? Crowfish. Crowfeet. Yeah. Your boy's off today.
Yeah.
I went to bed at 1:15.
Oh, boy. Save 10% of your paycheck. The earlier you start, the better off you'll be.
Yeah, there's that list where you Google it. You type in your age, and it's supposed to say, this is how much money you're supposed to have in your savings. If not, you're doing it all wrong.
Always makes you feel terrible about yourself.
It's the worst.
Yeah.
Don't Google it, y'all.
Yeah. Other things, go on all the vacations you can. Don't get so focused on work that you skip them.
If you like vacations, some people don't like to travel and go out and do stuff. Your point, I think when you have time off, do things that almost like a vacation for your soul.
Yeah, I think a vacation doesn't always mean traveling. I think a vacation is just taking some time for yourself to do what you want to do, things that are positive, that kind of reset yourself.
Things that give you a little joy and happiness.
Mm-hmm.
Do it.
Absolutely. Also, advice you would give to your younger self, don't settle. That applies to work, relationships, and everything else. How many the makeup or breakup emails do we have that just have that tone of, I'm settling? And it's like, girl, boy, whatever, walk away. You're in a bad situation.
I don't think I've ever told you that it's a makeup.
Yeah. And there's good reason, because there's a lot of people that are settling and they're staying in bad relationships.
And then 10 years from now, you're going to go, why did I waste the best years of my life?
Yeah.
Man, I know someone who's going through that. They feel like they've completely married the wrong person.
Tough.
Wasted a third of their life.
Well, it's not too late. You're never going to be this young. You're never going to be this cute as you are right now. It's never too late to get out there again.
Mm-hmm.
They're married. It's over.
Well, not really. They can get a divorce. If your spouse is making you miserable, you need to realize that that is a toxic situation and do better. Feel better about yourself.
Other advice to give to your younger self, collect memories and not material things. Okay.
Can we have both?
What if the memories you make are all about getting material possessions?
All my memories are about cute shoes and purses.
When Daddy took me shopping.
I remember that time so well. Relax and enjoy the ride.
That's a good one. Mm-hmm. I feel like a lot of times we don't. That was my biggest knock playing baseball my entire life. I loved baseball so much, but I didn't enjoy it like I should have. I put way too much pressure. It became this anxiety thing where I tried too hard. I didn't enjoy it, especially towards the back end of it. It wasn't fun. And I look back now wishing, going, man, I should have enjoyed it more. Mm-hmm. Playing ball with your friends, sunshine, smell of popcorn, Virginia.
Spend more time with your parents while you still can. Celebrate the little wins in life, not just the big ones.
I love that. Today, let's find some little win within our show today. Let's celebrate the hell out of it.
I love it.
It can even be breakfast.
Another piece of advice, look after your mental health. So there
yes.
you go. Yeah.
And eliminate people that try to snatch your healthy mental health. Just don't give them your time.
Mm-hmm.
Do you ever feel like a plastic bag drifting through the wind, wanting to start again? Do you ever feel this so paper thin, like a house of cards, one blow from caving in? Do you chance for you, 'cause there's a spark in you, you just gotta ignite the light and let it shine just on the night, like the 4th of July, 'cause baby you're a firework, come on show them what you're worth, make them go
you missed it. The KVJ replay is on 97.9 WRMF.
From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
Storm Smart provides homeowners with Storm Catcher Screens, the leading hurricane safety product on the market. Storm Smart Screens block up to 95% of rain and wind. Call 833-60-SMART or go to stormsmart.com for your free consultation. No major incidents at the moment on 95 or the Turnpike, but we do have a crash that has shut down Haverhill Road in the northbound direction. This between Cypress Lane and Stacy Street. Take Military Trail as an alternate. That's traffic. I'm Suits for 97.9 WRMF.
Rapids Water Park, Mega Thrills, Mega Fun, and coming later this spring, new Mega Mayhem, the first dueling water coaster in Florida. Visit now for spring break and come back for Mega Mayhem with a season pass. Save 45% and get a free souvenir cup now through April 3rd. Only at South Florida's Mega Thrill Capital, Rapids Water Park. It's Mega 2024.
Coconut shrimp is back at Pollo Tropical. We're serving a perfectly golden, sweet, and savory coconut shrimp in a bowl, platter, or as a side with our pineapple rum sauce. Don't miss out on coconut shrimp at Pollo Tropical. Try it today.
Hey, is your credit on life support? Take a deep breath. Listen up. Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach hosting a credit clinic at the dealership today and tomorrow. Yeah, it's Nick Rivers. Local bank representatives, they're going to be on site to grant special approval to consumers who meet certain minimum criteria. If you got a job bringing home $350 a week, the credit clinic at Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach, they want to approve you so you can drive home in your new Kia today. Yeah, Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach hosting a credit clinic at the dealership today and tomorrow. If you have a job bringing home $350 a week, the credit clinic wants to approve you for a new Kia. What are you waiting for? Don't miss the credit clinic today and tomorrow at Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach. Call 800-NEW-KIAS online, greenwaykiawestpalmbeach.com, and remember,
we want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
Credit affects down payment and approval terms.
The difference it makes when you switch out your windows and doors. I did it, and it took me 3 years to do it because I paid it off in phases. BNT will work with you, just like they worked with me. If you don't have all the money up front, you can break it up into three phases like I did. And now, bam, here I am. Last year was my first hurricane season with my house completely fortified courtesy of BNT windows and doors. Every window, every door, hurricane ready. It just gave me a sense of peace I had never had before. I gotta tell you, it was kind of nice to be like, well, I've done everything I can to fortify this home. Whatever happens, happens. It did give me peace. You want that peace too. Get it for yourself. Call BNT. You know, they use custom PGT products, and PGT makes the best-selling window and door on the market. Go online today, BNTWindowsAndDoors.com.
Looking for a memorable dining experience? Look no further than the Dolphin Bar and Shrimp House in Jensen Beach. Savor delicious dishes like their Shrimp House Mac or Tropical Shrimp Tacos. Happy hour is every day from 3 till 7 p.m. to enjoy half-off appetizers. On Sunday, stop in for their famous brunch featuring a waffle and omelet station and Bloody Mary and Mimosa Bar. And don't forget their 50-plus item salad bar. Visit DolphinBar.com to learn more and make your reservations. You can also follow them on Facebook and Instagram.
Hey, West Palm Beach, looking for new ways to save? Well, on Verizon, you don't need to be on a family plan to get our best deals. For a limited time, plans start at just $55 a month for a single line on unlimited welcome, with autopay plus taxes and fees. That's a savings of $10 a month. Plus, get a select phone on us and a $100 Verizon gift card when you switch. There's never been a better time to switch to the network America relies on. This offer won't last long. Visit your local Verizon store to switch and save big today. Minimum $599.99 up to $659.99 device payment or full retail purchase with new smartphone line on unlimited welcome plan required. $100 Verizon e-gift card sent within 8 weeks with port in. Less up to $659.99 promo credit applied over 36 months. 0% APR. $360 local promo credit applied over 36 months for new customers with one new line. Additional terms apply. In select markets only. Auto pay and paper-free billing required. For unlimited welcome plan in times of congestion, unlimited 5G and 4G LTE may be temporarily slower than other traffic. Domestic data roaming at 2G speeds.
South Florida weather is 15 seconds away from the H. Gregg West Palm Beach Weather Center.
Get ready for March Madness at hgregg.com on Military Trail. Score big savings with a slam dunk selection of pre-owned vehicles. They've got a lineup that'll make you feel like a champion on the road. hgregg.com, where every drive is a victory lap. Save more, drive happy.
A nice start on this Thursday morning. Temperatures throughout the morning in the mid to upper 60s. Then we're going to warm up to those low 80s this afternoon with the high 83 degrees with a mix of clouds and sunshine. Little chance for rain. That continues again today. I'm WPTV First Alert Meteorologist Jennifer Correa on 97.9 WRMF.
This report is sponsored by StormTight Windows.
When it comes to protecting your home, the choice is crystal clear. Get StormTight Windows and protect your home and family with South Florida's number one impact windows. Category 5 rated, StormTight Windows are steel reinforced for increased durability and security. If you want it done right, call StormTight.
The KVJ replay continues right now, only on 97.9 WRMF.
All right. Time for a fun little round of a game called What Did I Lick? Virginia gets to play along the game today. She's going to be blindfolded here in a minute. She's going to lick an object, and then she's going to have three guesses to tell us what the object is. We're going to excuse Virginia here as we let the audience know what the item is going to be. Okay, Virginia can head out right now. As soon as you're out the studio, we'll inform the audience what she's going to be licking here. Okay. Jay Bird has got it in his hands. You've got a yellow container. You open up the lid and you look inside there. And it's kind of a clear object. I will. Yeah. Oh, yeah. You don't
want don't
smell that.
That's a pungent box.
Yes, it is. It is a pungent box. It's got big smells in it. Now, if I hold this up to the camera, you can see it is. Looks like teeth. It's a clear thing. What this is a bleaching tray. So it's plastic. And then what you're smelling is the over. Yeah, I mean, that's spit and the bleach that you use together. And
that does not smell good, dog.
No, not a good smell.
That's kind of a foul bathroom smell.
So it's a foul bathroom smell, yeah. I mean, typically, you know, I do this. I run them under hot water sometimes, but, you know, I just did this and just kind of put cold water up for this round.
It's a. So. You should put it on your mouth real quick.
Think so?
Yeah.
I mean, I could do it.
Yeah, there you go. Really explore. There we go. Explore that thing. Get some.
Yeah, I'll fit. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that is cool. Yeah. That's how you.
You put a little bit of bleach in it, and then you put that on your teeth. You leave it for like 30 minutes.
Does that stuff work?
Yeah.
You just sucked on
it. Well, I had to, yeah, because it gathers a lot of spit. So, yeah, it's.
I think she does get it. She's good at guessing this stuff.
Well, she probably knows what it is because I imagine she might do it herself. So
that's why we gotta really. In fact, I kind of want to put it in my mouth now.
Okay. If she says anything mouth, we'll give her credit, like a mouth guard or you know a bleaching tray is the correct answer. But you know anything for that. So because after she licks this and finds out what it is, and if she gets shocked on top of it after missing three guesses, she's gonna be really upset.
Does she get mad at this one?
She's not going to be happy.
She ain't going to be happy.
She's not going to be happy, man. She's going to have that where she don't want to come off like she's so mad, but she's going to be mad. She's going to be kind of quiet and understated. And yeah. She won't say anything, and then she'll get all quiet when we go to commercial. She'll sit there. You know how she does that? She'll just sit there by herself. And
you got to tune into KVJ TV.
Watch her.
But just for commercial. Yeah.
Virginia will be sitting there quiet, just staring at it, just seething. But she realizes she makes too big of a deal out of it. Because, I mean, all the stuff she's given me and...
Oh, she can't get... Exactly.
She's going to be mad, though. Yeah, no doubt. Okay, all right. We can bring Virginia in here.
That's great analysis.
Yeah. That's what's going to happen.
Great profile.
Uh-huh. That's what's going to go down. I'm telling y'all. Just wait. Okay.
I think she's going to get it. I think our star... Oh, here's our star.
Here she comes. She's got a... bottle of Fireball in her hands. I guess she's thinking she might need to disinfect.
You know, she's got that blindfold on, which sucks because her eyes look so big and bountiful today. We don't want to be covering
her. Covering them up.
Her big
it's
eyes.
Too bad. It's too bad. Okay. All right. Virginia's in place in her chair. She's got a blindfold on. Can't see what it is. Now she can use her sense of smell and taste and, of course, the textures that her tongue will be hitting to try to guess what this item is that she is licking. Okay, she'll get three guesses here. Bird, present it to her so that she can start licking the item.
Okay. Open up, sweet baby.
Okay. All right, Virginia's tongue is out. All right, she's touching the item with her tongue right now. Okay, Virginia, are you smelling anything? Are you tasting anything? What is the texture upon your tongue? You can only lick. You cannot bite or chew or suck. It's only a lick, so that's it. Any context clues? What's going through your brain right now?
It feels like plastic. I don't taste anything.
Okay, no taste, any smell coming off of that?
I don't smell it.
Okay, all right, no real smell either. Okay, so that's not good. All you're getting right now is a plastic? That's about it.
Really explore, though. There you go.
Yeah, okay. She is. Okay, yeah. You kind of map that out with your tongue and your brain. Maybe you can start to figure out what the item is that you're licking.
Get it.
Okay. Any thoughts? What would you think right now, your initial
Oh, you know what? You got to do it again because no one saw it on KVJ TV. Your microphone was... Just do that same thing.
Okay. Virginia's licking an item right now.
I think I know what this is because I have one.
Uh-huh.
Is it a night guard that you get from, like, the dentist? It's like a tray that they...
Bingo. You got it. That's my bleach tray.
It's one of our sales guys.
Yeah. We actually got it in the garbage. Okay. Very good, Virginia. No shock for you. You got it on the first guess. Nice work.
I know Kevin has a clean mouth. It's not that bad. It's still pretty gross, though.
It is kind of gross, yeah. You could have definitely gotten worse. No doubt.
Let me tell you. Girl, you my little boo thing. So I'll give a hoot what you do. Say, girl, I know you a little too tame. I'll be shooting that shot like 2K. Girl, I know. Tell him I'm next. I see a brother holding your seat, no beef, but I'm trying to get the noise released. Don't take my talking to your own. I can keep it chill like the Soviet young blunt. I'ma keep it real when your man long gone. If you're looking for a friend and you got the wrong song, but girl, what's good? What's with ya? If you book tonight, that's fiction. I'm outside, no pictures. You want me? Go figure. To the back, to the front. You a 10, baby girl, but I'm the one. Hey, to the back, to the front. You a 10, baby girl, but I'm the one. My little boo thing, so I'll give a hoot what you do. Say, girl, I know you a little too tame. I'll be shooting that shot like 2K. Girl, I know. Tell him I'm next. Tell him you find a little something too fresh. I know. Tell him I'm next. Tell him you find a little something too fresh. I know. What you do, say, girl, I know you a little too tame. I'll be shooting that shot like 2K, girl, I know. Tell him I'm next. Tell him you find a little something too fresh, I know. Tell him I'm next. Tell him you find a little something too fresh, I know.
Time for a round of hook picks. These are rhyming riddles, and the answer to the riddle is going to be a pair of words that rhyme with each other. Virginia versus Jaber in a head-to-head battle. You're going to get 10 seconds to try to come up with the correct answer. Go on ahead, Bert. I believe you can put on the Hank Pink robe, correct, because you are the champ.
I'm the champ?
Yeah.
Oh, no, Virginia might be the champ.
Yeah, I think Virginia's the champ.
Well, I never got the robe when I got crowned champion last week. Somebody who won the prior week took it home and lost the robe.
I think this is all alleged, and there's still an investigation going on.
Well, where's the robe?
I couldn't find the robe, but I do have this bottle of Tahitian treat. It's all I could find. That was the closest thing to being pink in the back room.
We had that gorgeous robe that said Hank Pink's on it.
KVJ Nation made that for us.
It's probably at my... If I'm the champ, it's got to be at my house then.
It was customized.
Oh, you don't care. You don't care about any of these trophies or gowns.
Whatever. I wore the no-name movie game belt.
You didn't get to wear it at all this week.
I didn't get to wear it one day.
Oh, my gosh.
I plan on stinking up the camera tonight.
I wish you guys really did care about the Hank Pink robe and the no-name movie game belt. But you guys only like it because it puts a spotlight on me and being a jackass.
The only time we want to talk about it.
It's the only time.
When you lose it, now I'm in.
That's exactly the only time you guys like it.
Okay, one for practice so people understand what a Hank Pink is. If I say pheasant prison, you say...
Rat. No.
What?
What?
Nah. Rat? Did you say rat?
It's not going to go well for him today.
Oh, man. I have a feeling he's not going to win.
Quail jail.
Quail jail is what we'd be looking for, Virginia. Rat.
I meant to say rats. I'm not very good at this game. All right, get focused.
Okay. Get focused.
Let's go. Yeah, that's
you got
what
a big day today.
For.
Big day.
Okay, you got 10 seconds on the clock. Tell me what the Hank Pink would be. If you have a situation where you turn a clenched hand, what have you done? You turn your clenched hand. Two words that rhyme with each other.
Twist fist!
Twist fist.
Twist fist.
Is what you did.
mic up. Here we go.
Oh, I love the twist fist. When you hit somebody, just twist.
Yeah.
Grind it in there real good.
Right on their face.
Yeah. If you're wearing jewelry, it's even better.
You are very violent today.
She really is, yeah.
You got you.
Kind of scary.
You need a nap.
Yeah.
I do.
Yeah.
Really think you do.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. Nope. No sleep.
It's horrifying.
Okay, what about this? Tight fitting coffee mug. Tight fitting coffee mug. I may be giving you one of the words right there, too.
Tug mug!
Tug?
Snug mug.
Snug!
Oh, Virginia at the buzzer! Snug mug.
Snug mug.
That was a weak one.
Whatever. If you were to get the point, you'd be like, yeah, it was great, Kevin.
Tied at one apiece here. Could this do it right here?
Oh, we're only doing three today?
Well, we'll see here.
Well, you took so long not being able to find the robe. You killed all that time.
The nerve about prolonging a bit. The nerve.
Right.
Prolong Sinicky.
I have a list of 12.
Foot covering cube would be a what? A foot covering.
Sock flock. Sock.
Cube.
Sock.
Foot covering cube.
This is a hard rock. Ah, no.
Socks. Box.
Oh. Pluralized.
Sock box. Socks box. Got it. Got it. Got
okay.
it.
Okay.
All right. All right.
All right. What about
that
this?
That one's on us.
Okay. It's
a foot. You know, I think it's singular. All right.
What is a prying Boy Scout group?
Noisy Boise. Noisy Boise.
No.
Snoop Troop.
Snoop Troop. Virginia has it. And a win.
No!
Oh!
No!
You can go ahead and put the robe on me, homie. Oh. Homie, where's the robe?
Oh, evil wins again.
Yes.
My umbrella. Not a repeat, it's a replay. The KVJ replay on 97.9 WRMF. From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
Storm Smart provides homeowners with storm catcher screens, the leading hurricane safety product on the market. Storm Smart screens block up to 95% of rain and wind. Call 833-60-SMART or go to stormsmart.com for your free consultation. No major incidents at the moment on 95 or the Turnpike, but we do have a crash that has shut down Haverhill Road in the northbound direction. This between Cypress Lane and Stacy Street. Take Military Trail as an alternate. That's traffic. I'm Suits for 97.9 WRMF.
I gotta admit, I probably watch about four or five different platforms now, easily. And if I didn't have my Xfinity Flex, my streaming 4K TV box, it would be really tough to go from one to the other, but it's not a problem. All I do is I take the voice-controlled remote, I say it, and it plays it. It can jump around from my Netflix over to my Amazon Prime, whatever it is. It can get me there into the show I want right away. And you can get it with Xfinity Internet, which, by the way, is awesome, super fast, and reliable, and it comes with 20 million Wi-Fi hotspots all over America. And let me tell you, too, the Xfinity Flex 4K streaming box, it's an easy setup. You just plug it in, connect it right to your Xfinity Internet, you start streaming in seconds. Go to Xfinity.com or call 1-800-XFINITY. Xfinity Flex is available to Xfinity Internet customers, excluding Internet. Essentials and prepaid customers who do not have Xfinity TV, one-time $15 activation per account, limited to three devices. Currently, one device included with monthly Xfinity Internet service, additional devices, $5 a month.
Voluntary pre-kindergarten is a great way to get your child ready for school. And did you know it is free? If you have a child turning 4 years old before September 1st, now is the time to apply. You can send your child to any one of nearly 400 locations in Palm Beach County. To learn more, call 561-514-3300 or go to everyparentpbc.org/VPK. That's 561-514-3300 or everyparentpbc.org/VPK.
On an MSC cruise, beauty is everywhere. It's in the thrill of a waterslide, top-notch entertainment, and in quieter propellers. It's in the sunset and that toast on your very first night on board. Discover the beauty of Ocean Key, MSC's private island marine reserve, and more destinations with up to 40% off cruises, plus drinks, Wi-Fi, and more included. MSC Cruises, for a greater beauty. To book, visit msccruises.com or contact your travel advisor. Restrictions apply. Ships registered in Panama, Malta.
Spice up your life with the best, most authentic Tex-Mex grill in Palm Beach at Rosalita's in Lantana. They welcome you to the award-winning restaurant with only the finest meats, poultry, and fish dishes. A family-run restaurant since 1994. The minute you walk in the door of Rosalita's, you'll smell the aroma of delicious fajitas, burritos, or enchiladas made fresh to order. Their friendly staff is always ready to serve you with your favorite Tex-Mex dish, such as carne asada, fish tacos, baby back ribs, or Santa Fe salad, spinach, and chicken enchiladas. Or you can always go the lighter side with a tortilla soup and a taco salad. Rosalita's is open daily, starting with happy hour from 11 till 7, lunch and dinner. And there's always something fun going on at Rosalita's with karaoke on Tuesdays and Fridays and live music on Saturdays. What are you waiting for? Come and spice up your life. 561-964-5747 on the corner of Lantana and Congress.
Come and spice up your life at Rosalita's. Rosalita's.
I'm John Morgan of Morgan & Morgan. When I set out to build our firm, it was built for greatness. It was built for you. For over 35 years, my mission has been to deliver more for our clients, to deliver more for you. Today, Morgan & Morgan has more offices, more staff, and more lawyers than any other injury firm in the world. If you or anyone in your family has been injured, call America's largest injury law firm. Call Morgan & Morgan. ForThePeople.com.
Visit ForThePeople.com for an office near you.
Hey, Florida, are you ready to meet Birch Lane? It's Megan, and I am so excited. The first ever Birch Lane stores are now open, where you can shop high-quality, classic furniture and decor in person. Don't miss the grand opening sales all month long. Plus, get expert help on home projects with free design services. It's classic style for joyful living. Shop Birch Lane, a Wayfair specialty brand at Meisner Park in Boca Raton and at birchlane.com.
I'm Jason McIntosh, partner with the law firm of Lytle Ryder Smith Ivy and Fronrath. Our personal injury firm has offices throughout South Florida and is ready to fight for your rights. We have proudly represented residents of South Florida for almost 40 years and recovered billions for our clients. If you've been injured, call Lytle Ryder. You will pay absolutely nothing if we don't win your case. I encourage you to check out our reviews and see for yourself what our clients have to say. Visit Lytle Ryder at foryourrights.com. Main office, West Palm Beach.
Fargo, the new virtual assistant from Wells Fargo, makes banking faster and easier. Like this.
Fargo, what's my checking account routing number?
And this.
Fargo, turn off my debit card.
And this.
Fargo, what did I spend on groceries last month?
And that's just the beginning. Do you Fargo? You can. In the Wells Fargo mobile app. Learn more at wellsfargo.com/getFargo.
Terms and conditions apply. Your mobile carrier's availability and message and data rates may apply. Wells Fargo Bank NA, member FDIC.
Dr. Rosenthal is amazing. He did my daughter's rhinoplasty. He did my girlfriend's lower facelift, that beautiful lift, in office without any general anesthesia. Yeah, she was awake the entire time, and Dr. Rosenthal let me hang out there in the office and watch the procedure. Wild. It was the coolest thing. And now my girlfriend, she's in her 50s. She looks like she's in her 30s, okay? That lower facelift, that beautiful lift is amazing. And Dr. Rosenthal has been doing beautiful faces in Palm Beach County for over 20 years now. That's experience. He's a face expert. I love an expert. If you're thinking about anything, eyelids, rhinoplasty like my daughter did, she loves her nose, or the beautiful lift like my girlfriend did with Dr. Rosenthal, they are ready to help you look your best and feel your best. They are gentle. Go to Rosenthal-MD.com. You'll be so happy you did.
Experience the Anninger and Levine difference. Call 1-800-747-FREE.
From the Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach Studio.
We want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
This is 97.9 WRMF Palm Beach.
Okay, normal or nope? Is there something odd that you do that you're just wondering, are you the oddball or does everybody do this and they just don't talk about it? Bert, I'm sure you got a laundry list of stuff.
I do. Yeah. I do.
Uh-huh. Some of the ones that people are asking, they text into us, 877-979-WRMF. They said, I am a man who sits to pee.
That's normal.
Bert got me into doing it, and now, yeah, at home.
At home. At home. Only
yeah.
At home.
At home, yeah.
Only in porta potty.
Oh, no. In fact, yeah. I don't even know if I will ever go to a porta potty ever again.
Yeah.
It's better just to pee next to it in the grass and just take the ticket.
Four guys here, raise your hand if you sit to pee. Oh, Bert, just you and me.
Yeah, I mean, honestly, it's not every time. Usually at nighttime, if I'm waking up or in the morning, I'll sit down and pee. If I got people over and I'm drinking, I'm usually in and out, and I'll stand.
Okay. I think I stand to pee more than you guys because I stand to pee a lot. I like to hover because I don't really want to sit on the seat, and I do squats, a lot of squats now, so I just do squats while I'm peeing.
It's just about, it's just more comfortable at times. Sometimes, man, you know, like you had that one... That one stat, if you're not peeing within 17 seconds, something's wrong. You had some kind of a weird...
Oh, yeah. What? I have all kinds of weird stuff.
You don't remember that stat?
If you're not peeing within 17 seconds, you're wrong?
Something like... Yeah.
You're wrong.
17 seconds of what?
It was supposed to take a certain amount of time.
for you to clear your bladder.
Oh, the length of your urination.
That's what it was.
Yeah, something like
that. Oh, I pee for like a minute and a half.
And I think that's not good.
Well, I have like a giraffe's bladder. It's so big.
One person said, I sit down in the shower to relax.
I do too.
Yeah, I was going to say, I thought that was something you did.
Mm-hmm.
Does that mean it's normal though?
I don't think it is normal. I would be, I think, in the weird category.
Anybody else? Raise your hand if you sit in the shower to relax.
When I'm hungover, I do.
Only and Bird.
I just sit there and think of all the things I regret from the night before.
Is this normal or odd? I think about death a lot in the shower. That's when I really I think about, yeah.
That's nope.
When I'm in the shower, a lot of times I'll think, yeah, the murderer could be breaking into my house right now, and I can't even hear him because all I can hear is the shower. And when he comes busting through the door of the bathroom, there's really nothing I can do. I can't even prepare.
So you're saying you do think about murder in the shower?
I do.
But I think about it differently. You're thinking about getting murdered. I think about just death in general on a... It just may, I don't know. Showers may, I don't know.
Anybody else raise your hand if you think about murder in the shower? Okay, there's nobody else, Bird. It's just you and Virginia.
I don't think about murder. I think about death. She thinks about murder. I think about murder when I'm on
I think about death, too.
I think about murder when I'm on the couch, Kevin.
Mm-hmm. Anybody else not change their loofah until it's completely destroyed?
I don't use a loofah. That's gross.
I think loofahs are disgusting, and they should have went out in 1988. I think it's such an old-timey thing.
It makes me feel so clean.
The only time I would use a loofah is if I'm opening the package, and I use it that one time, and then I throw it away.
Even loofahs...
What do you use, then?
I use my hands and the bar of soap.
I feel like a hand does the trick.
I have body wash. I rotate my cleansing soapage.
Yeah, I use my hands too, and I feel like I do a great job. Loofahs are gross. Even if you live by yourself, just time and slime and grime.
Wow. Some people use a washcloth, and then they wash that in the laundry, just like when you wash your towels. That's what a lot of people do, but I was raised to use my hands.
I always heard washcloth on the face is bad for the skin. It's for the face skin.
Yeah, maybe. You know, maybe it's too much exfoliation.
What do I know? I grew up in Lake Park.
Okay, normal or nope? Washing my toothbrush before I use it.
Normal. I always will wash my toothbrush.
Now, when you say washing, what does that entail?
I just make sure I just rinse it off just to make sure the air and time and
Before you put the toothpaste on?
Yes, I always wash off my toothbrush.
Do you do that, Virginia?
Never, because I do a dry brush. My toothpaste that I use, that AP24, the whitening toothpaste, it tells you to get best results, don't get it wet, use it dry.
I knew it was going to be a pretentious answer.
Yeah. Just had a feeling, huh?
Yeah. Kevin, what toothpaste?
Look, my mouth is wet enough. You know I am a moist woman.
She is. She's got a very wet mouth.
Okay, wet mouth, huh?
I don't need to wet the toothpaste and the toothbrush because the teeth and gums are moist.
Wet mouth, Sinicky, they call her in DeCosta.
Is this normal or nope? Sleeping like you're in a cocoon, head covered, blankets wrapped around you like a sleeping bag, and face covered except for your nose and mouth. I do that.
Yes, and that makes that a lot. Me think, does anyone ever, to get yourself asleep, do you ever picture yourself as a hostage and you escaped and you're on a boat or in a car and you can't let them know you're there?
I'm going to go with a nope on that.
You're
Virginia.
A hostage.
Yeah, but you can't be, but you escaped and you're trying to get home and you are...
Yeah.
It's a little trick I play.
It's a little tricky play.
It relaxes me at night. It's an odd thing.
Yeah, I do kind of like when I'm trying to sleep, I do sometimes pretend like I'm hiding from something or somebody. Yeah.
Me too.
So it's like all about being quiet. So yeah, in a way, I don't know if I'm ever a hostage, but...
Or you're like a kidnapped victim, or I always feel like I've escaped from like a prison of sorts, or...
A lot of times I'm like, I'm an assassin, and I've got to, you know, lay and wait, and I can't make a noise.
The enemy will find you, but I'm in the enemy's boat, and I got to get back to shore.
Oddly enough, I think we're both kind of weird that way.
And it relaxes
it doesn't
me.
Feel like that. Doesn't feel like that's normal, but we're both crazy in the same way.
That is awesome. You kind of get what I'm saying.
I kind of get what you're saying on that, actually.
Thank God.
One person said... I want to know, normal or nope, I go multiple uses before cleaning my air fryer basket. Like, I use it daily, and I wash it maybe one time a week.
I do the same thing. Yeah. And when I finally do rinse that thing out, it's kind of gross.
Right.
I don't know what to tell you.
I think it's normal.
It's normal. Uh-huh. It's normal.
Okay.
Normal or nope, I have to close every window I have open on my phone before putting it on Do Not Disturb before sleeping.
That's...
I can see that. I am pretty good at closing. I don't like phone clutter, so I do clean it up a lot.
You just don't like clutter.
I don't, no.
Phone, life.
Yeah, anything. Yeah, so I get that. Is this normal or nope? Sprinting out of a room when you turn the lights off so the demons down there don't get you.
I get that first. I totally get that first.
What? Kind of going to lean nope on that? Do you ever run from a room, Virginia, so the demons don't get you?
No, I kind of do the opposite. So
okay.
When I go into a room in my house and it's dark and I can't see, I like challenge the ghost. I get like a puffed up chest and I'm like, I'm not scared of you, but I kind of am really scared of them. But I want them to think that I'm not scared of them. So I like kind of get like fake ballsy.
Okay.
And before I turn on the light, I'm like, I'm not scared of you.
Hmm.
Yeah. No.
Is that crazy?
No. You gotta. Sometimes back in the day, I used to act like I was Scott Hall, my favorite wrestler. If I was in a situation that made me feel uncomfortable, and I'd have to like mentally go, "All right, you're Scott Hall right now. You ain't scared of nothing." So I get it.
You can psych yourself up to be not scared of nothing. It is a real thing because if you tell your head that you're not scared of nothing and you keep saying it, you kind of become it.
I think sometimes people are afraid to do silly tricks because they look silly. Saying this out loud, there's some silly stuff we're saying right now.
It works.
But it's honestly, it's part of the human condition. Just embrace being weird. Humans are weird.
You're not weird. You're normal.
Yeah.
You're normal because we all do this, but the more you tell yourself in your head, I'm not scared, I'm a badass, the more you become a badass.
At least twice a day when I'm going to walk to pee at my house, I always act like right before I get to the bathroom that I'm like pump faking and shooting a ball as I get fouled. Like it's a phantom basketball game. And I always sink it.
I always get
the foul as well.
Oh man. And normal or nope, enjoying the smell of your own farts.
Enjoying or smelling? Those are two different things.
Yeah.
I think kind of enjoying, being like, I did that.
I think that's a thing. That's in the fetish world.
It's weird, but I think it's normal. I think a lot of people do that.
I don't enjoy them, but sometimes you do need to know what's going on. And I think that is something in you. Chemically, that you are supposed to be checking yourself for issues, problems, internal stuff that's not going right. And farts and poop are an indicator of stuff that's not going right inside of you.
That's just being a human and taking stock.
It's totally
He's
being a human.
You're into it. You're enjoying it. Like, oh, yes. That's a different... That is not normal.
Well, now you're a freaky little monkey.
Yeah, I would say you're not normal. That's okay. A nope.
That's fun.
I don't know how to feel, something I wait for, something I'm made for.
Oh, these are things that really kind of need to be called out. Disgusting habits that people do but don't even realize. It's just kind of like create some awareness with y'all. Is you gross?
I think one is picking their nose and kind of examining it and then eating it.
Oh, my gosh.
Kevin, you'd be surprised how many adults do that.
Do they really?
Yes.
I don't know if I've ever seen that.
I know, man. It's a weird thing. I told you about this one girl. She's really, really hot.
Yeah.
And everyone knows that she picks her nose. She'll pick it. She'll look at it. She's been seen putting it in her mouth.
How
I
is
know another
that?
Person that does that. That's an adult.
What?
It's a thing.
How do you know all these booger eaters?
Oh, man. He runs in these gross circles.
I will say the girl's not. She's really not my friend.
Okay.
She's a friend of a friend. So
okay.
It's like gross friend light.
Okay. That's amazing. Some of the disgusting habits people do that don't realize they need to be called out. One is women who pee all over the toilet seat in a public bathroom and then leave it like that for the next person to use it.
Is that a hovering situation, Virginia?
It is. If you're a hoverer and you pee all over the seat, you should wipe it down afterwards because not everybody hovers. Some girls come in there hot and they sit right down and they're sitting in your urine, and that's not cool.
Do we have that situation here at work?
I've seen it.
Wow.
I have seen it. I've seen some sloppy bathroom habits here.
Yeah. Be aware of it.
You shouldn't
Fix
leave
it.
You shouldn't leave anything behind that shows you were there. Leave no trace.
Yeah, I like that. It's a good like, bathroom policy.
It's that theme of Burning Man, which they did not do this year, but leave no trace.
You're right. I was in the work bathroom last week, and somebody left pHs around the toilet, if you know what I mean. No traces behind. Exactly.
You're shedding?
Yeah, no
like a
shedding.
Cat? Exactly. It's crazy.
It is crazy.
Not closing the toilet before flushing. Once upon a time, I didn't realize how gross that was. And if you've ever seen that animation of just how many germs are flying out of the toilet when you flush it, you'll be aware.
Yeah, it'll make you close the lid.
Yeah. Yeah, change
because you're going to breathe it. If you don't, you don't want to breathe that.
It's gnarly. Yeah.
No matter how clean you get a bathroom, it's going to be gross.
Now, the way I am, I close the lid and I flush the toilet and I take off running.
You know too much.
Like I've set off a bomb. Some other disgusting habits people do but don't realize. Not wiping down your machine at the gym. That is pretty gnarly. All the bacteria in your sweat. People are sweating all over it and just walking around from one place to the next. And some people are drippy at the gym. And that is gross, man. People coughing into their hands, especially when they're in a greeting line.
Ooh.
Hello, nice to meet you. Hello, nice to meet you. I would be like, I'd do that.
But then I've
have
seen,
to skip that one.
I've seen people cough into their elbow. They do the Dracula or the vampire.
Yes.
But they'll have a long sleeve shirt on or they're coughing into their sleeve and now they've got cough sleeve.
Yeah, but I think that's better than doing it into your hands because you put the germs on your hands and hopefully nobody's shaking your sleeve. It's still not awesome. But, you know, I guess if you got to sneeze and you got to do what you got
to
do.
Well, what are you supposed to, what's the best way? Cough into what, the ground?
Yeah, I mean, you got to cough somewhere, right? If you have to cough, yeah. Another disgusting habit people do but don't realize, constantly sniffling instead of just blowing your nose.
Wonder who has that in the studio.
Who does that?
Sniffling Stephanie over here.
Oh, man. When she really yanks one back.
She has no idea she's doing it either. And she's a loud gulper. You ever hear her drink anything? Gulps over here.
I prefer to say she's a passionate drinker.
Like, how's that taste? It sounds delicious.
So refreshing.
Another disgusting habit that people don't even realize sometimes, people who touch food after immediately handling cash.
Cash is nasty,
man. It is. you got to watch, too, because a lot of times you'll see that, like, the cashier is making your sandwich, and then they go over and touch money in the cash machine. And ugh.
I also saw a no-no here done at work. There were donuts out at the table, and the person opened up the donut, the donuts, grabbed one donut with their hand, put it back down, and then grabbed another donut.
What?
That is not...
You touch it, then it's yours.
I feel like you can't window... If you're in a window shop, you can't use it with your hands.
That is not cool.
And that's why Virginia never, ever eats anything that leaves the studio.
You can't trust. You cannot trust the people that you work with, because that fingers Frida fingering all the donuts before she figures out which one she wants.
Does that gross you out? If something good and you're really, really hungry and you knew someone grabbed it really quick and put it back down, does that take away?
It's tainted. It's done.
It's done?
It's dead to me. Okay. It's like it didn't exist.
And you're also an animal, because if you're going to touch the donut and then put it back, it just means that you have no manners or regard for people that you work with.
I saw it done in real time.
Tell me who it is.
I can't. I'm not.
You got to tell me.
Commercial break.
I need to know.
Need a boy who can cuddle with me all night. Give me one, let me long, be my sunlight. Tell me lies, we can argue, we can fight. Yeah, we did it before, but we'll do it tonight. Yeah, that Afro black boy with the gold teeth. Your dark skin looking at me like you know me. I wonder if you got the G or the B. Let me find out and see you coming over to me. Times, but I got nothing but love on my mind. I need a baby while I'm in my prime. Need an adversary to my down and weary. Like, tell me that's life when I'm stressing at night. Be like, you'll be okay and everything's alright. Let me in nothing, cause I'm not wanting anything. But you're loving your body and a little bit of your brain. These days are way too lonely. I'm missing out, I know. These days are way too long. And I'm not forgiving, love away, but I want someone to love me. I need someone who needs me. Cause it don't feel right when it's late at night and it's just me and my dreams. So I want someone to love. That's what I really want.
I want to know what you guys know about love here. There was a survey of 1,000 Americans, and I want to see if you guys know what the majority of people said. First question they had asked was, is there such a thing as love at first sight? You both said yes.
I think it's possible. I don't think it happens often, and I don't think it happens to everybody, but I think you can connect with somebody and you get a feeling and it works out. I think that's that can happen.
Yeah, 70% of Americans said no, there's not. And they would say what you're feeling is infatuation. And it's not love at first sight. I had the same thing happen with the Queen, honestly. I remember when she walked in, she was like, oh my gosh, that girl's amazing. And then
you married her.
Yeah. And day one, we, you know, hung out, had an amazing time. Day two, we had a better time. And it was just, you know, every day was awesome. So
Exhibit A, Your Honor.
Yeah. Love at first sight. Got him.
I'm kind of more with you guys. But yeah, 70% of Americans, man, are saying there's no such thing as love at first sight.
Much like our chat room, they don't believe in love.
Yes. Are you able to be in love with more than one person at once? What do you think, Virginia? Yes or no?
I mean, I'm sure it's possible. Yeah. I mean, you can totally love two people at once.
Okay. What do you think, Bird?
I think you can. I think it's possible to really love, be in love with two people. Just don't let them find out about that.
Yeah, okay. You better keep them separated.
A majority of Americans, 58%, said no, you cannot. You would be in love with one person. You may like the other, but to have that deep connection of what you would consider love, they're saying no.
I don't think they've seen The Bachelor.
No, right? A lot of love there. Do opposites attract?
Opposites, in my opinion, and look, there's always, you know, room for flexibility and all these things, but I think opposites are great for attraction physically. You guys can physically get together, but as soon as you start being opposite of matters of the heart stuff,
yeah,
good luck having fun with that, man.
What do you think, Virginia? Do opposites attract?
I agree with the bird. I think carnally, yes, but long term, no. I think you should try to be on the same page with, you know, morals, religion, how you want to raise kids. Like, fundamentally, it helps if you agree.
I feel like physically people can get past certain things. Some people don't have to like each other to get physical. But if you have to, yeah, like Virginia's saying, those matters of the heart moment, and then your opposite, ugh. It's rough.
Now, 82% of Americans say that opposites do attract, but the core principles still need to be similar.
Well, then.
And I think that's kind of defeating itself. I agree. Because if you're saying, well, no.
They're saying both things.
Right. And that's why I don't think you can answer that way.
All right. This survey is on the verge of really getting on my nerves.
Right? Okay. What do you think about this? Should you wait a certain amount of time before contacting somebody after a first date?
I think all that stuff's silly. I think everything depends on the moment. There's been times where I think it's the right move to wait. And then there's been times where you have more of a connection with, and it kind of organically happens.
What do you think, Virginia?
Every situation's going to be different. Because you hear about people that go either way. And I think you have to feel it out and make your own terms.
Every situation is different on that one.
Okay. 84% of Americans say, no. I mean, that's for the kids. You contact somebody when you feel like contacting them. Stop playing these stupid games.
Exactly.
You're not in high school. And finally here, what do you know about love? Should you take your husband's last name when you marry, Virginia? What do you think?
If you want to have kids and you want the family to all have the same name, then I think you should. But if you don't plan on having children, especially if you're an older, established woman who's got her career and her... No, I think it's a old, antiquated thing that should not be required of a bride.
Okay. Where are you, Bird?
Yeah, I think I've changed my perspective on this. I mean, I do like the old school. I think it's romantic when you've got a couple that loves each other and they do the old-fashioned thing. But that's how, you know, I was raised. I like it, but I kind of don't think it's that big of a deal anymore. I think a lot of these old-fashioned things we have. I personally like it.
Still a big thing. 79% of women still take their husband's last name after marriage.
I like it.
I've had so many last names. It's confusing. At this point, right. I kind of like my OG last name. It really was like the hardest of all of the names I've had to say. So that's why I let that one go. But I mean, I wrote McGrain the other day on something by mistake, and I'm like, that hasn't been my last name in how many years?
It's
confusing.
When a couple's in love and they share the name, I like that. But to me, it only works if you really like each other.
Yeah, 5% are hyphenating their maiden name with their husband's last name.
That just makes it longer.
It does.
I don't want to. It's a lot of pen ink.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sometimes you'll see that on Facebook. You go, oh, she's hot. Oh wait, she's got 9 last names. I guess she's married. I'm so confused.
Because you just can't get enough KVJ. The KVJ replay on 97.9 WRMF. From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
Storm Smart provides homeowners with storm catcher screens, the leading hurricane safety product on the market. Storm Smart screens block up to 95% of rain and wind. Call 833-60-SMART or go to stormsmart.com for your free consultation. At the moment, no major incidents reported on 95 or the Turnpike, and you are up to speed for the most part. However, coming up this morning around 8:30 a.m., Donald Trump is expected to travel to Fort Pierce for a court appearance. And at that time, you will see rolling roadblocks on 95 northbound between the exits of Forest Hill Boulevard
and Orange Avenue, and you can expect heavy delays when that does happen. So if your commute typically takes you through that area at that time, try to seek an alternate route this morning or make sure you give yourself plenty of extra time. We do also have a crash to watch for that is tying you up at the moment on Indian Town Road. Look for this one right at alternate A1A. Plus, in Broward County, there is a crash blocking a right lane on the turnpike. This is northbound right at the exit for Sunrise Boulevard. Expect delays on the approach to that area. That's traffic. I'm Suits for 97.9 WRMF.
At Kia Delray, there's something for everyone. Right now, get great deals on all new 2024 Kia models. And at Kia Delray, you get the best price guarantee or Kia Delray will pay you $500. Plus, your new Kia comes with a 2-year, 24-month complimentary maintenance schedule and the industry-leading 10-year, 100,000-mile warranty on all new Kias. Local heroes, police, fire, military get half off on service or accessories. Kia Delray, 2255 South Federal Highway in Delray Beach, or visit KiaDelray.com.
It's a big deal, and it's an amazing thing that they are offering right now at Life Imaging FLA. We've heard the stories, the testimony of people that have gone to have the heart scan done at Life Imaging FLA. They thought they were healthy, and the news came back, oh my gosh, you have a major blockage. And they rushed people from Life Imaging FLA to the hospital for emergency life-saving surgery. This is real, and this is happening, and these people wouldn't have known about the blockages if it hadn't been for Life Imaging FLA.
And it's so ridiculously easy to do. It takes 10 minutes. There's no dyes, no need to undress. There's just a few minimum requirements, and you can find out the answer. It is free, a $699 value for you.
Go and do this for yourself. Do it for your peace of mind. Do it for your family. You know, 30 to 40% of heart attacks, the first symptom is sudden death, and you just drop.
All you have to do right now is from your cell phone, call #250 and say the keyword free heart scan. That's #250, keyword free heart scan.
Hey, honey, I have a great idea for summer vacation. Let's go to Chicago. We can take the kids to the aquarium, the Navy Pier, and maybe even a baseball game. We can eat deep dish pizzas and Chicago-style hot dogs.
That's a great idea, and the kids will love it, but only if we fly from PBI.
Chicago, here we come.
Let's book our flight today.
Already on it.
Palm Beach International Airport, South Florida's award-winning and favorite airport. Now flying direct to Chicago. Visit PBIA.org for more info.
Looking to make a change and start your weight loss journey? Hey, it's Suits from the KVJ Show. And I got to tell you, I am loving the way I look right now because I dropped 30 pounds and I was able to do it in just 2 months with the help of Coastal Weight Loss Secret. Dr. Adam Zuckerman and his team over at Coastal Weight Loss Secret have a unique weight loss program that made it easy for me to lose that weight, get healthy, and get my energy back naturally, safely, and effectively. If you've tried weight loss programs in the past and have been unsuccessful, maybe you couldn't lose the weight, or once you did lose the weight, you put it right back on as soon as the program ended, you've got to give them a call. With Coastal Weight Loss Secrets, you can lose that unhealthy fat without counting points or calories. There's no exercising required, no surgeries, and none of those expensive prepackaged meals. They can help you find out the secret to losing up to a pound of fat every day, and then once you lose that weight, they'll help you keep the weight off. Schedule a free consultation today with the team at Coastal Weight Loss Secrets. You can reach them at 561-680-3090. That's 561-680-3090, or visit them online at Coastal WeightLossSecret.com.
Demand Dave! 844-411-1LAW. Demand Dave! For a car accident or slip and fall. Need a personal injury lawyer? Comrest and Comrest. Make the call. 844-411-1LAW.
Jay Bird, oh, I love me some Dunkin', and I am hungry like a horse or a hippo. Dunkin's got deals galore. In fact, my dad got his wake-up wrap yesterday. He told me, hey, Bird, I'm at Dunkin', I'm getting my wake-up wrap. He loves them. There's so many great things at Dunkin' that I love as well. I love the hash browns. I love them stuffed bagel minis. Download their app, too. DD Perks membership's going to get you deals galore, my friends. I am Jay Bird, and I run on Dunkin'.
South Florida weather is 15 seconds away from the H. Gregg West Palm Beach Weather Center.
Get ready for March Madness at hgregg.com on Military Trail. Score big savings with a slam dunk selection of pre-owned vehicles. They've got a lineup that'll make you feel like a champion on the road. hgregg.com, where every drive is a victory lap. Save more, drive happy.
A nice start on this Thursday morning. Temperatures throughout the morning in the mid to upper 60s. Then we're going to warm up to those low 80s this afternoon with the high 83 degrees with a mix of clouds and sunshine. Little chance for rain. That continues again today. I'm WPTV First Alert meteorologist Jennifer Correa on 97.9 WRMF.
This report is sponsored by Morgan & Morgan Injury Law Firm.
I'm John Morgan of Morgan & Morgan. If you've been injured in an accident and would like to know the value of your case, go to forthepeople.com to see cases just like yours. You see, all lawyers are not the same. Morgan & Morgan.
Visit forthepeople.com for an office near you.
South Florida runs on Dunkin', and so do we. Dunkin', the official coffee of 97.9 WRMF.
To more of the KVJ replay, only on 97.9 WRMF.
Well, over the weekend, I saw a photo of Tyler Perry's mansion in Atlanta. Have you ever seen that thing?
It is no joke.
My goodness. That's crazy. It looks like some kind of French palace that you would see out in the countryside.
It's
unbelievable how huge this thing is. In fact, I think he has, if I remember right, right off the highways, you're driving into Atlanta, at least coming in south from the city. He's got his own exit.
The whole exit is his?
Yeah, I remember seeing like an exit thing for Tyler Perry. I was like, wait, Tyler Perry's that way? It's pretty crazy.
You know you've made it when you have your own exit.
It's pretty good. Yeah, it's a good sign. So he is a billionaire. But at what age did it happen? And did it happen sooner for him or for Oprah Winfrey? Who do you think made $1 billion sooner in their life, Virginia? Oprah or Tyler Perry? What would you guess?
You think, like, how long it took them to make it? Is that what you're saying?
At what age? Yes.
Oh, who had it younger?
When they could say they were a billionaire.
I think it's Tyler.
You're Tyler Perry. You are wrong.
Everyone knows this, Virginia.
By a year, he hit it at 50. Oprah hit it at 49.
Wow.
Close, though. All right, Bird, what do you think? Elon Musk or Jeff Bezos? Who was younger when they hit billionaire status?
Only talking Musk.
Gonna go Musk.
We're doing great.
Mm-hmm.
You can tell we run in these high money circles.
It's Jeff Bezos. He was 35. When he became a billionaire from Amazon.
That's too young.
Elon Musk was 41.
You shouldn't be a billionaire in your 30s. It's too much power.
Too much, huh?
That's just so
too much too soon.
You don't deserve it yet.
I don't think any human does.
Well, wait till you hear this next one. What do you think about this, Virginia? Who was younger when they became a billionaire? Bill Gates or Mark Zuckerberg?
It was old Zuck.
You think it was Zuck? You are correct. Mark Zuckerberg became a billionaire at the age of 23.
Yeah.
It's 23 years old and he's a billionaire.
It's too much.
He's peaked.
That's crazy.
It's just so much power. I get it.
It is a lot. 23-year-old billionaire.
When I was 23, if someone would have given me $1 million, it would have been a hot mess.
Dude, when I was 19 and I got a little extra in my student loan, I could play around a little bit. Yeah, I thought I was the king for about a semester.
Pretty crazy. Pretty crazy stuff. Bill Gates was 31 when he hit that
slacker
status. I know, right? What took you so long, Bill? What about Jay-Z or Rihanna? What do you think about that? You had to guess.
She got it before he got it.
Just to be difficult, I'll go Jay-Z.
It was Rihanna.
Good job, Virginia.
Rihanna was 34 when she became a billionaire.
Dang.
Jay-Z, 50 when he could make that claim. Palm Beach athletes, Michael Jordan or Tiger Woods? Who was younger when they got to billionaire status, Bird?
It's definitely 23. Michael Jordan, betting my face on it.
Betting your face? Your face is gone.
Dang.
You big dummy.
You are wrong.
A lot.
Yeah, and by a lot.
This is really highlighting how wrong I am.
All right, who's removing his face?
Tiger Woods was 33 when he became a billionaire. Michael Jordan had to wait till the age of 51.
them Hanes. Is it the Hanes that crossed them over?
Them Air Jordans.
Yeah, I think it was Air Jordan. I had a buddy that has seen the Matt Damon, Ben Affleck movie that they did about that, saying it was pretty amazing. That was really it. It was Michael Jordan's mom that said, yeah, not only are you going to use his name on these shoes, but we need a cut. And they're like, well, that's just not what we do in the sneaker industry. She's like, all right, well, then we will.
Go scratch.
Yeah. And mama said, nah. Imagine if she wouldn't have done that.
Wow.
That was a game changer right there.
Thank you, mama.
Yeah. And it changed the way they do sneakers. He was the first to get a cut of his own sneaker.
Good for him.
And what about this? Who made it to a billionaire status at the younger age? Mark Cuban or Warren Buffett? Who do you think was younger when they became a billionaire, Virginia?
Buffett looks like he's always been old.
And always rich, so it's hard.
It's very hard.
Old and rich, he's always been.
Cuban's more young and lippy looking.
Definitely.
He's got a lot to say, that Cuban. Mm. Buffett kind of, he don't say too much.
Okay.
I'm going Cuban, lippy and large.
Okay, do you agree, Bird?
I don't agree with a lot that she just said, yeah, but I do agree it's Mark Cuban.
Okay, it is Mark Cuban. He was 40 when he became a billionaire. Warren Buffett had to wait to the age of 56.
Dang, you slacker.
Yeah, become a billionaire. So there you go.
Waiting all day for you, babe. So won't you come sit and talk to me and tell me how we're gonna be together always. Hope you know that when it's late at night, I hold on to my pillow tight and think of how you promised me forever.
I never thought that anyone
could make me feel this way.
Now that you're here, boy, all I want,
it's just a chance to say, hey, get out of me right now. It's the end of you and me. It's too late now. And I can't wait for you to be gone. Cause I know about her. Ooh. And I wonder why? How I brought all the lies. You said that you would treat me right, but you was just a waste of time. Tell me why you're looking so confused when I'm the one who didn't know the truth. How could you ever be so cold to go behind my back and call my friend? Boy, you must have gone and bumped your head because you left a number on your phone.
So now the road is set and done.
Maybe I'm the one to blame,
but to think that you could be the one.
Well, I didn't.
You and me. It's too late now. And I can't wait for you to be gone.
toddlers have to be the most unreasonable humans on the planet, right? They have to be.
I was just thinking that yesterday.
Have to be. It is the most difficult age where you can't do anything right. If you ever get frustrated with the women in your life, Jay Bird, have a toddler. Because there's just no winning.
They're insane, and they don't want to do anything that's good for them. They only want to do bad for them.
Yeah.
It's just, it's hard.
What's the official age of a toddler?
2 to 4, I would say. Is that about right?
Yeah, that okay. Sounds right.
It's a tough age. They talk about the terrible twos, and that's really when it starts, where they just, I don't know, I guess they can't figure out their body or their mind or both.
Well, they're probably just now coming to grips with all of these images and sounds, and they're just trying to figure it out.
And, you know, they have an agenda, which is cookies and candy.
Food, yes.
You have an agenda, which is trying to keep them alive and healthy.
And they have a weapon. It's crying. And they understand that when meltdowns, tears, all that stuff gets your attention, then they really start, they weaponize it. And that's when it gets really difficult. I was asking, what dumb thing caused your toddler to have an epic meltdown on our Facebook page? Got a lot of texts that have already come in. Somebody said, my 2-year-old baby girl wanted a cookie. So I gave her a cookie. But before giving it to her, I took a bite out of it. Big mistake. Total epic meltdown.
Kind of on the kid's side on that one. I mean, don't eat my cookie.
Again, it's manipulating for snacks and sweets. Somebody said, my 3-year-old threw a fit Sunday for 45 minutes because I wouldn't put on blue eyeshadow.
So as a parent, what do you do? If the kid is having a meltdown.
It's really tough because here is the issue. You are like, I can't give in to this little terrorist. But at the same time, those tears and the yelling and everything else, and especially if you're tired, which you always are if you're a parent with a toddler, that you're just like, okay, and you're doing ridiculous demands. Your life is commanded. Like, what are you doing?
I put glitter eyeshadow on Rocco because he wanted it on Saturday. Mm-hmm. And then on Sunday, we were going to actually see other people. He had a meltdown because I wouldn't put glitter eyeshadow back on him on Sunday again.
Well, it makes him pop.
But this is the stuff you're dealing
down.
With. Yes.
Talking about eyeshadow.
Somebody said my 2-year-old wanted me to put on the Mickey Mouse Club, so I did. And then she freaked out after asking to watch it.
Yeah, they'll see something they don't like, and then they'll start screaming, and it's your fault.
What's the Mickey Mouse Club putting on there?
Hot dog, hot dog, hot diggity dog.
Oh, that's a jam.
That is the
that's
jam.
That's still going strong, the yeah. Mickey Mouse Club. Good for them.
Mickey kills it.
Mm-hmm. Kristen said, my daughter once cried because I wouldn't let her eat my son's tooth that he just lost. That causes an epic meltdown. Mary said, I wouldn't let my son have the kitchen chair because it was broken and he would have hurt himself. That's a lot of times it, too, where you that's where the loss is. And you just have to accept the meltdown, unfortunately. You need a soundproof room.
Oh, my gosh. That'd be great.
Just put them in there. Nice little timeout. You close the door. You can't hear a sound.
Every now and then, though, I'm going to defend the toddlers. A meltdown is justified and fair. I remember being a toddler, like around 3 or 4. Mm-hmm. We had this big German Shepherd. He dropped the biggest dump on the ground in the house. And my parents blamed it on me and thought I did it. And I had a meltdown defending myself.
Your poo looks like dog poo?
They thought I
you are Big Poo Pennington then, because, man, if you were putting that in a diaper, were they confused that?
I was a toddler. Wow. I've heard this story so many times, and there was a meltdown, but I didn't do it.
How big a logs were you dropping?
You must have had the largest baby dumps.
I don't know.
Because I'm very good at that. Dog or human, like, I can tell every time.
Every time.
Every time.
I was innocent.
I don't know.
Whoa.
I was innocent.
Mm-hmm. Let me see. Jen said, my son keeps having meltdowns because of the YouTube ads that interrupt the Paw Patrol.
Okay.
They're annoying, though, to the kid's defense.
But after a few seconds, you can skip the ad.
Mm-hmm. Not all the time. They have some ads on there that'll go 30 seconds.
Rocco had a meltdown because nobody would Zoom meeting with him. He keeps like Zooming my friends.
Oh.
And people send me screenshots. They're like, your son tried to Zoom message me. I guess he downloaded my contacts into his phone. And so I'm getting messages like this. Your son's trying to Zoom call me.
Have him Zoom. I'll Zoom with him.
He started melting down and screaming because no one would accept his Zoom meeting.
I will accept. Send him to me.
There
I'll
you go.
Zoom
he,
with him.
He and Jay Bird.
All right.
Found your Zoom partner. And Amy said, my toddler had an epic meltdown because I asked him to pick up my phone off the floor for me. And he said, no. So I picked it up and then he freaked out.
Dude, what?
KVJ Replay on 97.9 WRMF.
From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
Storm Smart provides homeowners with storm catcher screens, the leading hurricane safety product on the market. Storm Smart screens block up to 95% of rain and wind. Call 833-60-SMART or go to stormsmart.com for your free consultation. At the moment, no major incidents reported on 95 or the Turnpike, and you are up to speed for the most part. However, coming up this morning around 8:30 a.m., Donald Trump is expected to travel to Fort Pierce for a court appearance. And at that time, you will see rolling roadblocks on 95 northbound between the exits of Forest Hill Boulevard
Airport and Orange Avenue, and you can expect heavy delays when that does happen. So if your commute typically takes you through that area at that time, try to seek an alternate route this morning or make sure you give yourself plenty of extra time. You are moving a little bit slowly right now on the turnpike in both directions of the West Palm Beach Service Plaza. There's also an accident to watch for on Malaluka Lane that is tying you up. Look for this one at Mulberry Street. And in Broward County, 95 northbound, currently under speed between Copens Road and Hillsborough Boulevard. That's traffic. I'm Suits for 97.9 WRMF.
Want more speed? Then you're in luck, because Xfinity just increased their internet speeds, and they're faster than ever. Plus, with super fast internet and a reliable connection, you can do more of what you love whenever you want. More gaming, more downloading, more video chatting, and more cozy nights on the couch streaming your favorite movies and TV shows. If life with double the speed is sounding pretty awesome, that's because it is. It's time to get more out of your internet with faster speeds from Xfinity. Get 150 megabit Xfinity internet for only $20 a month for 12 months with no annual contract. That's double the speed for the same great price. Plus, for a limited time, learn how you can get a $100 prepaid card when you get more speed when you sign up online. Just go to Xfinity.com to switch today. Requires paperless billing and autopay with stored bank account. Restrictions apply. Equipment taxes and other charges extra. After promo, regular rates apply. Actual speeds vary and not guaranteed.
If you haven't been to a Berry Fresh Cafe, you probably don't realize how cool they are. At Berry Fresh Cafe, it's locally owned by a family. The same family that owned RJ Gators for like 15 years now brings you Berry Fresh Cafe. Go check them out. Eat fresh, buy local, and be well. Courtesy of Berry Fresh Cafe in Stewart, in Jupiter, in Port St. Lucie, and the brand new location at US 1 and PGA. If you're like me, and you care a lot about the bar, they have a full liquor bar with beer and wine, mimosa flights, Bloody Mary flights, the mega, mega, mega mimosa, which sounds so good, fresh pressed juices, and bacon infused vodka. It's family owned and operated. You're going to love it. Go check them out. Berry Fresh Cafe. Eat fresh, eat local, and be well at Berry Fresh Cafe.
Hi, I'm attorney Robert Rubenstein, and this is Rubenstein's Rules for Personal Injury. Rule number 9, head injuries are serious. You can get a brain injury from bad whiplash without even hitting your head. Sometimes symptoms of a traumatic brain injury can be subtle. Watch out for changes in personality or behavior. Your family may notice it first. At Rubenstein Law, we make sure all of your injuries are addressed, especially head injuries. Call Rubenstein Law at 1-800-FL-LEGAL. Offices in Palm Beach and throughout Florida.
Hey, Florida, are you ready to meet Birch Lane? It's Megan, and I am so excited. The first ever Birch Lane stores are now open, where you can shop high-quality, classic furniture and decor in person. Don't miss the grand opening sales all month long. Plus, get expert help on home projects with free design services. It's classic style for joyful living. Shop Birch Lane, a Wayfair specialty brand at Meisner Park in Boca Raton and at birchlane.com.
The Jeep Celebration event is going on right now with exceptional offers on a wide selection of Jeep brand vehicles. If you're looking to supercharge your next adventure, look no further than America's best-selling plug-in hybrid, the Jeep Wrangler 4xe. Or choose the luxurious Grand Cherokee or Grand Cherokee 4xe. All celebrations must come to an end, so hurry and visit Jeep.com or your local Jeep brand dealer for great deals during the Jeep Celebration event. Based on 2022 CYQ4 sales, J.D. Power retail sales data. Jeep is a registered trademark.
Hey, it's Kevin here from the KVJ Show, and I want to tell you about this revolutionary weight loss medicine called Revelex. It is proven to work. Now, you probably heard about semaglutide with all the celebrity buzz. It's an FDA-approved drug for weight loss, but nobody offers it like Red Mountain Weight Loss. Red Mountain Weight Loss includes full-strength semaglutide with their Revelex. But Revelex is half the price of other semaglutide medications. It comes in a full-strength daily tablet, so there's no needles, just results. Get with Revelex and get started on losing up to 15 pounds per month. Imagine shrinking your belly, hips, and thighs all while eating a wide variety of foods like cheese, nuts, bacon, coffee, creamer, dark chocolate, and even alcohol. Red Mountain Weight Loss offers one-on-one support from medical experts so you can ensure and maintain your weight loss for life. It's available only by prescription, and you can only get it at Red Mountain Weight Loss. Dial #250 from your phone and use the keyword Red Mountain Weight Loss. That's #250, keyword Red Mountain Weight Loss.
This is Scott Trout of Cordell and Cordell. If you're a dad who is facing divorce, there are extra layers of stress that may include stereotypes and assumptions. No two situations are the same. Our legal experience and dedication prepare us for whatever legal challenges we face together. For more than 30 years, Cordell and Cordell has represented men in divorce.
Offices in Miami-Dade County and Fort Lauderdale. Schedule an appointment with one of Cordell and Cordell's attorneys. Se habla español. Legal services available in English and Spanish. Lisa Cartes, Florida resident partner. Scott Trout, licensed in Missouri, Illinois, and Georgia only. CordellCordell.com.
Strax Aesthetics unlocks the secret to great cosmetic surgery. Have surgery now and pay later. Breast augmentations and tummy tucks, less than $150 per month for qualified patients. Extreme weight loss with a gastric sleeve procedure. The Strax Med Spa offers Botox for $9.99 per unit and unbeatable prices on Juvederm. Guaranteed to beat any comparable quote. Schedule a free face-to-face consultation with your actual board-certified surgeon. Saturday appointments available too. Visit StraxPlastics.com or call 954-749-3040 for more info.
Experience the Anajar and Levine difference.
Call 1-800-747-FREE.
From the Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach Studio.
We want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
This is 97.9 WRMF Palm Beach.
Longer, I know I got to be right now, because I can't get much stronger. Man, I've been waiting all night now.
I really like Stronger. It's one of my favorite Kanye West songs. Hearing him side by side, I think I got to go Kelly Clarkson on that.
No, not for me. I'm going Kanye.
It's not even close. I'm definitely going Kanye.
Okay, going Kanye on that, huh?
And I love Kelly, but yeah. That Stronger by Kelly is not one of my favorite Kellys.
And then when the Kanye song kicks in.
Oh, that yeah. Kanye is
it's solid.
Banging.
No doubt. Okay, we got a song here called Hello. Two people did. The song called Hello. One of them is named Adele. The other one is named Lionel Richie. Who wound up doing a Hello song better?
Cause you know just what to say.
Yes.
And you know just what to do.
Sing it, baby.
And I want to tell you so much.
Hello from the other side. I must have called a thousand times to tell you.
Ooh, okay.
Talk about a battle royale.
Yeah, we're slowing down on that one, boys and girls.
Out of nostalgia, I'm going Lionel Richie. I grew up with that song. That's my hello. Which one's yours, Virginia?
I agree. I'm old. We're going Lionel.
I'm definitely going Lionel, and I highly recommend everybody go watch the official music video of that song. It is
weird.
It's 80s.
It is weird, it's 80s. Man. He's a professor and he is following her around. It's, I don't know.
Hashtag me too.
It's a little weird, man.
Ain't gonna play today.
No, it's not.
Ain't gonna play today.
Some stuff does not hold up.
All right, we got two songs, both with the name Angel. Who did it better, Shaggy or Sarah McLachlan?
Girl, you're my angel. You're my darling angel. Closer than my peeps.
All I see is sad dog faces.
Oh, sorry, sad dogs.
Oh, there's a sad cat.
Oh, look. It's crying.
Yeah, I love me some Sarah McLachlan, but that's not the one. I'm going to go Shaggy's Angel on that one.
I'm going Shaggy, too. There's also an
Aerosmith Angel.
That's the one that should be in there.
That is the best Angel.
I would pick that one over those three, but out of those two, I'm going Shaggy.
Okay.
Only because that has such just a... It's animal heartache.
Yes, I think it's forever branded in
it
your brain.
It is the song of dog death.
I can't hear that without Thea.
Yes, so yes.
Sad. All right, we got a song named Creep. Both Radiohead and TLC had songs named Creep. Who had the better Creep? They're both amazing songs. I love them both. I am actually going to go TLC's Creep on that. I like the sound of that because the Radiohead for me gets a little whiny sometimes if I had to listen to it over and over again. What are you going with, Virginia?
I love me the deep throaty sounds of T-Boz, but if you're going up against Radiohead Creep, there's no way. I got to go Radiohead.
even though Radiohead hates it, I love it. I love that song. I've been listening to that song since I was a teenager, and I'm still not burned on it.
Okay.
I love that song.
It's so fun to sing.
I love the high part.
Yes.
You can't sing it, but it's nice to listen to.
Oh, I try.
Mm-hmm. Give us a taste.
It sounds like somebody's skinning a cat.
Come on, give us a little taste.
Never.
Okay, and I've got a song here called Jump. Both Van Halen and Criss Cross did a song, Jump. Who has the better jump? Wow, both great songs.
That's the toughest one right there because I like both of those songs a lot.
They really hit, both of them. I'm going to give it to Van Halen just because of the musical mastery that goes into that song. Criss Cross does hit, but I'm going to go Van Halen. Who you got, Bird?
Man, this is such a tough one. I got to go jump Van Halen too, but it's close.
Virginia?
Just because of the video and the inspirational roundhouse jump kick that David Lee Roth did. Me and my friends would all try to do it and mimic what we saw in the video. That changed things.
I love that part. I got my back. When it goes in that one part, that part's cool.
So cool.
That is good. Okay. All right. got some random questions to throw out at you here today, including, what do you think with this? Fill in the blank. Even if I was starving, I wouldn't eat blank.
Crawfish, Kev.
You would if you were starving.
I mean, you're right.
I know you're being dramatic right now.
I'm being dramatic.
But. You don't love it.
I loathe. I mean, it really is. And after we did that last crawfish bit where you made me eat crawfish poop and intestines and all that, and I got sick, it's even at a different level of hatred.
Crawfish, tofu, or beets? What would you least have to have a nonstop diet of?
Raw tofu, when it's cold and it's not doctored up or seasoned, it's pretty darn rough. It's pretty gaggable.
Yeah, that's it. Just raw tofu.
Give me the beets. I can't believe I'm saying it, but yeah, beets.
Out of those three, huh?
Out of the three, to me, beets are the least offensive.
Okay.
Liverwurst is pretty rough, but if you were starving, you'd probably eat the liverwurst and be happy.
Do you have a food, Virginia, that you just don't even know if you could choke down even if you had to?
I think the concept of like Vienna sausages, like meat in a can, kind of grosses me out.
You would eat, but you're starving though. They taste too good for them to be.
If I'm starving, I think I would eat anything.
This is why we have a tough time with bits and consuming. We do segments and bits where Virginia's got to eat something or consume something. She's tough because she's Cajun and she pretty much can eat anything like a goat. Nothing shakes you. The only thing that shakes her is blue Kool-Aid. Oh.
Just can't do.
She's tough, man. Because you would definitely get down on Vienna sausages.
I would. I wouldn't be happy, but I would do it. I mean, if I was starving, I really would eat anything. I mean, shy of cannibalism, I'm down.
Yeah, I guess the answer for her is human.
Human. Yeah.
Okay.
And you probably could doctor that up and Cajun that up and make it taste good.
I feel like your butt cheek, I could blacken it and it'd be delicious.
She could make a great Cajun dish out of my body. I believe in you.
I make a butt cheek gumbo out of you.
We posted this question. We posted this question on the KVJ Show Facebook page. Liver and onions, probably the top response. People said that even if I was starving, I wouldn't eat blank.
It'd be pretty rough. Raw onion and liver.
Some people love that.
Yeah, they lived in the Depression.
I don't get it.
It does sound pretty depressing. Cottage cheese was up there.
It's not real cheese, as we all know. I don't know why they put cheese underneath it, and it is disgusting.
A lot of people responded with that.
I love cottage cheese.
It makes so much sense.
I love it.
Yep.
I can eat it plain. I can eat it with fruit. I can eat it just with a little bit of like sweet, a little bit of salt. It goes so good with everything.
Oh, okay. The texture is awful. The taste is gnarly. If you leave it out for more than 10 mins, it starts to sweat.
Big curd, small curd. I like it all.
Bird don't like the curd.
I saw a lot of comments for Brussels sprouts. That's one of the top answers.
If you doctor them up, but you're right though, are you able to doctor them up for the game? I'm not respecting the game right now. You have to eat raw Brussels sprouts.
Yeah, probably. Because, yeah, I got some last week and they're absolutely amazing.
They can be good. So for the sake of the game, they're raw. They're awful.
And I'd seen what had happened with Brussels sprouts. Apparently, somewhere along the way, they realized they were good for you, but they had just this kind of flavor that was really bad. Somebody went in and identified what it was and genetically took out that one piece that was making Brussels sprouts so bitter and nasty, and they've had a resurgence because of it.
Well, can they go back to the science lab and take out the thing that makes them smell like farts? Because if you cook Brussels sprouts in the house, no matter what the result is, you may doctor them up, they may taste great.
Do they
but
really?
The beginning process always smells like farts.
Dang, okay.
Go back to the lab.
I was surprised how many people were saying raw tomatoes.
Oh, I love tomato, but it is. It's a controversial food.
Okay. And then a lot of people saying oysters as well.
Amen. Raw oysters are gnarly.
I know a lot of people can't get past the oysters.
But it's one of those ones where the people that love them, they defend it. They love the oyster community so much. And then you got people like me. Burn them all down.
Okay.
I think it's how you grow up, too. Like, I grew up sucking down raw oysters and loved it. And for me, it's just normal.
We barely cross over with the foods we like.
You are so not me when it comes to, like, what you buy.
With that said, do you want the bird to buy you breakfast today? Because I know I can get something we both like.
We do come together on like a breakfast bagel.
We do. When Virginia doesn't get sleep and she's all tired, yeah, that's when we match up with our
That's
our
how
food.
You get her. That's how you get her. Okay, what is the worst experience you've ever had in a restaurant? Worst experience.
Oh, it's easy for me. Me and my dad walked into a Chinese buffet type restaurant, and when we walked in on the floor, our feet it would stick to it.
Oh, that's tough.
And we looked at each other and go, that's pretty gross, but we were so hungry.
Yeah.
And we walked up to the buffet and saw about 40 roaches scamper underneath as if they
saw you.
They saw you and they you know, went underneath. So as soon as the human would leave, they'd come back up during work hours and run amok on the buffet.
Oh, man.
We left immediately.
Yeah.
The sticky combined with the roaches that all fled underneath it was pretty gross.
That's pretty gnarly.
And then we ended up going to McDonald's instead. I remember it very vividly.
It's a good
call. Wow. Yeah. I've never had that crazy of an experience.
It was rough.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
Do you have one?
Yeah, mine would be the maggots that I got. There was a maggot crawling on my plate. I had gotten the... it was like the chicken taco kind of thing. And
this is the story you told on the air that everyone, you wouldn't tell what restaurant it was, so yeah, everybody had a guess.
Yeah. That was rough. That and then the Lee press-on nail that was floating in my water at a bagel joint one time.
That's gross.
Oh, that's rough.
That's now out of business. This is probably mine. Virginia, do you have one?
Not that bad. I mean, I had a ladybug in a salad. That's not bad.
That's good luck.
I had a part of a glove in like a wrap. But, you know, I mean, it happens.
That's nothing compared to roach rock party.
Roach buffet is gnarly.
It was rough.
I've never come close to that.
The thing that kind of shocked me, you know, when we were talking about what you wouldn't go to, all you can eat buffets, just, it turns my stomach. But I saw today that apparently they're making a roaring comeback.
Yes!
And apparently now all-you-can-eat buffets are even more popular than before COVID.
COVID what? Remember, we had the topic, it was probably 3 weeks into COVID. Buffets, are they dead? No, you can't kill a buffet.
No.
Get that zombie buffet.
Yeah, it's
now
a zombie buffet, which is even grosser.
I get why people find it gross. Because I've seen it. I've seen it turn gross. I get it.
I've seen places that have a buffet, and you look and, like, the walls are dirty. And you look at, like, the chairs, and they're all stained. I'm like, no. If they're not even taking good care of the front of the house,
yeah,
can you imagine what it looks like in the back of the house? So I can't eat at that buffet. Now, a place like the Breakers that does their brunch buffet, that's a buffet I can endorse.
Okay, what about a mom and pop's pizza buffet? I know a place that has they do a daily buffet, and it's all pizza, and you walk up and... Gross?
No, I think it can be good. I think it just has to be clean. I have to look around and feel like, okay, these people care.
You're right, though. If you look around a restaurant and the walls are grimy.
I went to one recently. It was a buffet place. Rocco wanted to go. I was not into it, but I went for him, and the walls were grimy. The chairs were grimy.
Can I guess what place this is? I'll write it down.
You might not know this place. It was in Boca.
Oh, that's way too bougie. I don't know about that.
But I was like looking around going, do y'all not notice that there's like stains on the walls?
Right.
Has no one ever noticed to wipe down these walls?
You would think it would stand out.
There's like splatter of food on the baseboards. Am I the only one that sees that?
You can't be. And I wonder how that, if you're the manager there, how do you not notice that?
They do.
You could get a Clorox wipe, and it could be done. You could take care of that.
Mm-hmm.
And it didn't look like it was fresh splatter, either. It looked like it had been there.
Nice. Yeah, they say that a lot of the reason for the resurgence of the all-you-can-eat buffet is the cost of items. People are looking for a good value right now.
You're right.
I do miss sweet tomatoes. And every time I bring up sweet tomatoes, I'll get 9 emails. Bird, that place is crap. It's disgusting. Poopy cramps in a bowl. I love it.
And if you have a big appetite,
yes,
like a lot of Americans do, if you're all about that portion size and getting my money's worth,
right,
but you're going to get what you want.
Buffets don't start turning gross until you get through that second plate because you're now full. And you're still trying to eat. You don't have that hunger driving the madness anymore. You know what I mean?
Now you're like, I just got to get my money's worth.
You finally kind of came to, and then you kind of, it starts to settle, and you look around and go, I'm kind of grossed out now. I ate too much. But that first plate.
All this stuff is grossing me out in my body. Yeah. It's not a good feeling.
Get the check.
Just in case you missed it, the KVJ replay is on 97.9 WRMF. From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
StormSmart provides homeowners with storm catcher screens, the leading hurricane safety product on the market. StormSmart screens block up to 95% of rain and wind. Call 833-60-SMART or go to stormsmart.com for your free consultation. At the moment, no major incidents reported on 95 or the Turnpike, and you are up to speed for the most part. However, coming up this morning around 8:30 a.m., Donald Trump is expected to travel to Fort Pierce for a court appearance, and at that time, you will see rolling roadblocks on 95 northbound between the exits of Forest Hill Boulevard and Orange Avenue, and you can expect heavy delays when that does happen. So if your commute typically takes you through that area at that time, try to seek an alternate route this morning or make sure you give yourself plenty of extra time. You are moving a little bit slowly right now on the Turnpike in both directions of the West Palm Beach Service Plaza. There's also an accident to watch for on Malaluka Lane that is tying you up. Look for this one at Mulberry Street. And in Broward County, 95 northbound, currently under speed between Copens Road and Hillsborough Boulevard. That's traffic. I'm Suits for 97.9 WRMF.
I have so much fun showing people the Kia that I'm driving around in. People can't believe it. You know, a lot of people in my personal life, they thought that the Kia brand was like a first car, a starter car. I'm like, no, let's learn about Kia together. These are tricked out, redesigned. Kia lured away one of those German engineers from Audi, and this guy has changed everything. The look of these cars, the interior, the technology, the luxury. Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach is overstocked with these amazing new Kias. If you haven't driven a Kia, you need to get to Greenway Kia and go be impressed. I certainly have been. The Tellurides, the hybrids, the K5s, the Sportages, and the Sorento. I love these vehicles. If you make $350 a week, they want to approve you. Call 1-800-NEW-KIAS or go to KiaWestPalmBeach.com.
We want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
Hey, West Palm Beach, looking for new ways to save? Well, on Verizon, you don't need to be on a family plan to get our best deals. For a limited time, plans start at just $55 a month for a single line on unlimited welcome, with autopay plus taxes and fees. That's a savings of $10 a month. Plus, get a select phone on us and a $100 Verizon gift card when you switch. There's never been a better time to switch to the network America relies on. This offer won't last long. Visit your local Verizon store to switch and save big today. Minimum $599.99 up to $659.99 device payment or full retail purchase with new smartphone line on unlimited welcome plan required. $100 Verizon e-gift card sent within 8 weeks with port in. Less up to $659.99 promo credit applied over 36 months. 0% APR. $360 local promo credit applied over 36 months for new customers with one new line. Additional terms apply. In select markets only. Auto pay and paper-free billing required. For unlimited welcome plan in times of congestion, unlimited 5G and 4G LTE may be temporarily slower than other traffic. Domestic data roaming at 2G speeds.
Once you meet Dr. Rankin face-to-face and you see the way he is, his zen personality, his amazing, healing, talented, gifted surgical hands, you're like, okay, this guy knows what he's doing. And at the Aqua Plastic Surgery Center, Dr. Rankin runs the show. He has put together the team. It's he, Dr. Bauermeister, and the female plastic surgeon, Dr. Dizelle. They listen and they care. They want you to feel your best and live your best. They know that you being safe in their hands is so important. They make sure that every patient feels safe and that they listen and care about their patients. If you're thinking about anything body, these are the body experts. Liposuction, mommy makeovers, breast lifts, breast explanting. Go see the pros in Jupiter or in Boca, aquaplasticsurgery.com.
On an MSC cruise, beauty is everywhere. It's in the thrill of a water slide, top-notch entertainment, and in quieter propellers. It's in the sunset and that toast on your very first night on board. Discover the beauty of Ocean Key, MSC's private island marine reserve, and more destinations with up to 40% off cruises, plus drinks, Wi-Fi, and more included. MSC Cruises, for a greater beauty. To book, visit msccruises.com or contact your travel advisor. Restrictions apply. Ships registered in Panama, Malta.
Rosa. price of your life with the best, most authentic Tex-Mex grill in Palm Beach at Rosalita's in Lantana. They welcome you to the award-winning restaurant with only the finest meats, poultry, and fish dishes. A family-run restaurant since 1994. The minute you walk in the door of Rosalita's, you'll smell the aroma of delicious fajitas, burritos, or enchiladas made fresh to order. Their friendly staff is always ready to serve you with your favorite Tex-Mex dish, such as carne asada, fish tacos, baby back ribs, or Santa Fe salad, spinach, and chicken enchiladas. Or you can always go the lighter side with a tortilla soup and a taco salad. Rosalita's is open daily, starting with happy hour from 11 till 7, lunch and dinner. And there's always something fun going on at Rosalita's with karaoke on Tuesdays and Fridays and live music on Saturdays. What are you waiting for? Come and spice up your life. 561-964-5747 on the corner of Lantana and Congress.
Come and spice up your life at Rosalita's. Rosalita's.
Hey, it's Kevin here from the KVJ Show, and I want to tell you about this revolutionary weight loss medicine called Revelex. It is proven to work. Now, you probably heard about semaglutide with all the celebrity buzz. It's an FDA-approved drug for weight loss, but nobody offers it like Red Mountain Weight Loss. Red Mountain Weight Loss includes full-strength semaglutide with their Revelex. But Revelex is half the price of other semaglutide medications. It comes in a full-strength daily tablet, so there's no needles, just results. Get with Revelex and get started on losing up to 15 pounds per month. Imagine shrinking your belly, hips, and thighs all while eating a wide variety of foods like cheese, nuts, bacon, coffee, creamer, dark chocolate, and even alcohol. Red Mountain Weight Loss offers one-on-one support from medical experts so you can ensure and maintain your weight loss for life. It's available only by prescription, and you can only get it at Red Mountain Weight Loss. Dial #250 from your phone and use the keyword Red Mountain Weight Loss. That's #250, keyword Red Mountain Weight Loss.
South Florida weather is 15 seconds away from the H. Gregg West Palm Beach Weather Center.
Get ready for March Madness at hgregg.com on Military Trail. Score big savings with a slam dunk selection of pre-owned vehicles. They've got a lineup that'll make you feel like a champion on the road. hgregg.com, where every drive is a victory lap. Save more, drive happy.
A nice start on this Thursday morning. Temperatures throughout the morning in the mid to upper 60s. Then we're going to warm up to those low 80s this afternoon with the high 83 degrees with a mix of clouds and sunshine. Little chance for rain. That continues again today. I'm WPTV First Alert Meteorologist Jennifer Correa on 97.9 WRMF.
This report is sponsored by Morgan & Morgan Injury Law Firm.
I'm John Morgan of Morgan & Morgan. For over 35 years, my mission has been to deliver more for our clients. Today, Morgan & Morgan has more offices, more staff, and more lawyers than any other injury firm in the world.
Visit forthepeople.com for an office near you.
Experience the Anajar and Levine difference.
Call 1-800-747-FREE.
The KVJ replay continues right now, only on 97.9 WRMF.
Now, I remember back to the high school days, you know, for me, it was always about trying to stretch your independence and get away with stuff. Now, I don't know whether it be sneaking out or wearing clothes you weren't supposed to wear or listening to music that you're not supposed to listen to. I don't know if you heard the story about Pete Davidson. He had bought an Eminem CD as a kid, and his mom wouldn't allow him to listen to Eminem. She just thought he was a little too dirty. And so he bought a Rod Stewart CD case, and he kept his Eminem CD in the Rod Stewart case. And so his mom saw the Rod Stewart CD case and thought he was a big fan of Rod Stewart, and she was too. So she would always play Rod Stewart with him all the time.
Aww.
So he got stuck in this curse of having to listen to Rod Stewart. He even had to learn Rod's music to keep the lie going. So, yeah. So I remember as a kid always trying to hide stuff. Did you ever sneak out, Virginia?
Oh, all the time. I would sneak out probably every weekend.
I snuck out one time. I went to, funny enough, the dog track as a 16-year-old and won
You went
money.
To the kennel club?
I went to the kennel club with two of my buddies, won money on the very first bet I ever did anything. Me and him went in on halves, and we got a quinella, and I think we won $47. We were jumping up and down as if we won $1 million.
That's a big deal.
It is a big deal. When you're that age,
it was.
$47 is a lot.
And then we went after the dog track, we went to the Rocky Horror Picture Show, and I was my mom found out I got in trouble.
Oh yeah.
I remember the big thing I did was, you know, when we were younger and I hadn't had my driver's license yet, I was still 15, we would take out my dad's car because he would ride his bike to work, and my mom was in Paris for the summer.
Wow.
So, yeah. So that was a fun time for Kev. But I remember one time we were out and riding around. My dad had this old car. It's called a Toyota Tercel. It basically was a tin can with four wheels. And so we would ride out on these backcountry roads where I grew up. And we would always wind up in ditches. But the car was so small that all the big old farm boys that I was riding around with could actually pick the car out of the ditch. And they could put up, but one time we got stuck and it took us a little bit of extra time. We couldn't get it out of the ditch. So I had to race home before my dad got home. I'm like, we're all good. But the thing I forgot was there was a huge clump of sod coming out of the back wheel. My dad's like, okay, wait, how does the sod just appear in the back wheel? So I got busted. So yeah, what did you have to hide from your parents? One person texted in and said, yeah, I had a tattoo on my chest when I was 15.
Oh, my.
Till I moved out of my parents' house. And I always wore a shirt 24 hours a day, and the parents never did find out.
Wow.
I hid an adult magazine, and my mom found it, and I was so embarrassed. Just because she knows what I'm doing.
Which one? It was Jugs, wasn't it?
It's Jugs. No, it was Playboy.
One of the classier.
It's way classier. It's a Playboy.
Only the finest.
But that's stressful. Hiding that from your family or your mom. My mom would just sometimes randomly go in and clean my room or do some deep clean, and that's how she found it.
I used to hide stuff on the roof of my house. I had this like little box, and I'd put stuff in there, and then I'd hide it on this part of the roof that the weather didn't hit it.
What were you hiding?
All kinds of stuff. Like I would write like journal entries and put it in the box. I would just any kind of little things.
Booze?
No, I don't really think I had booze, but any of my prized possessions. I had a side hustle in high school, so I would sell candy. And then I used to keep all my profits in my little cash box.
Look at you, entrepreneur.
would I have thought that was hot, or would I have, that's an interesting kind
I
of
I sold stickers and candy.
What age?
Oh, from the time I was probably in middle school all through high school.
What a hustle.
So you were known as like the sticker and candy girl?
Oh yeah, I had all kinds of
in high school
side hustles going.
That's weird.
Just make a little extra money, huh?
Yeah.
Hey, I had to get some scratch from somewhere. My mom wasn't giving it to me.
I like it. I think it's awesome, but it's just weird.
I spent all my money on candy. That was what I wanted. I wanted candy money. And a candy bar was 27 cents.
So that was your poison back in high school? You were just a candy junkie?
I was a candy junkie.
Okay.
Big time.
I respect it.
Candy and snowballs. That was my addictions.
Now, when you say snowballs, do you mean the...
Like a snow cone, but in a cup.
Yeah.
In New Orleans, that's like a famous thing. Like snow...
All right, okay.
Snowballs. A lot of people call them snow cones, but in New Orleans, it's snowballs. That's a big, big thing.
I love a great snow cone, but... They're all not created equal. There are some whack snow cones out there.
So shaved ice is the way to go. It's all about the ice. If it's a true New Orleans snowball, it's got this ice that's just, it's not clumpy. It's not chunky. It's not hard. It just kind of melts in your mouth, and it mixes with that syrupy sweetness. Mm-hmm. Put a little sweetened condensed milk on top. Oh, it's so good.
Do we want breakfast today? It's on the bird. And Mama, I'll order whatever you want. You want French toast? I'll get you French toast.
I kind of want breakfast.
You
want it? You want
that kind of weekend, huh?
No, definitely.
What do you want, keto Kev?
I'm good.
You want a salad?
I'm good. I'm still trying to get my body right.
I feel so off.
Yeah.
I only talk to God when I need a favor. And I only pray when I ain't got a prayer. So who the hell am I? Who the hell am I to expect a savior? Oh, if I only talk to God when I need a favor. More Sundays drunk off my ass than I have in church. Hardcover King James, only been saving dust on the nightstand. And I don't know what to say by the time I fold my hands. I only talk to God when I need a favor. And I
Like Hail Marys, if you're still there, Lord, spare me. Oh, my God, Hail Mary. Hanging in there, just barely throwing up prayers. Like Hail Marys, if you're still there, Lord, spare me.
Well, we all do dumb things. Sometimes we're little kids. Other times we are drunk adults. Can you tell the difference? Thanks for all the submissions. Just download the WRMF app. Use the mic drop feature in the bottom left-hand corner. You can send us some audio. Tell us a dumb thing you did. Leave a little space and explain if you're a little kid or a drunk adult. We've got Sarah who did something dumb. What was it, Sarah?
I gagged on wasabi peas thinking they were candy.
Okay, yeah, oh, those things are hot.
If you think you're getting a sweet treat and you get hit with the heat of wasabi, that is a shocker.
It could be, this could go either way.
It feels like a little kid to me, maybe.
Me too.
I totally do this when I was drunk, though.
I think it's a little kid, too.
I'm going to go drunk adult.
I think an adult would be aware of what wasabi peas are, though. And even if you are hammered, it doesn't look like candy, does it?
It all looks like candy when you're hammered, Kev.
Okay. They do put it in a, like a little bowl, like a candy dish.
Okay. So what were you, a little kid or drunk adult?
I was a drunk adult, and me and some girlfriends had a night out of drinking. And when we got back to their place, I was completely starving. So I saw what looked like candy and grabbed a handful, shoved them in my mouth, and realized they weren't candy. They were wasabi peas, and I hate wasabi. I ended up gagging on them and couldn't get something to wash them down quick enough, so never again.
Okay. You gotta watch them wasabi peas. All right, I got a submission that came in here. This is from Henry. What is the crazy thing that happened to you, Henry?
I got kicked in the face by a mule.
Kicked in the face?
Oh. Dang.
What the heck, dude?
Jaybird got kicked by his party horse at his birthday.
That was a pony that was in my gut, and that was, man, right in front of my crush, too.
Could you imagine if it would have been the face?
That would have messed me up. I would not be the Jaybird.
Oh, my goodness.
Because it kicked me real hard in the gut. If that would have gotten my face, I don't think I would have ever recovered.
Did you start crying?
Did I start crying? Yes, it was so embarrassing.
He wants to cry now thinking about it.
And then my mom got mad because too many people came to the party and ate all the food. So she's having a meltdown. It was a horrible party.
Yeah. I'm thinking as a little kid because I'm thinking about how high a mule can kick. I think it'd be more kid face level.
Totally.
Way if you got kicked in the face. So go little kid. What do you think, Bird?
I'll go little kid on this.
Okay. What were you, Henry?
I was a drunk adult. I tried milking the mule, and it kicked me in the face.
Oh.
It took 14 stitches to close the wound.
Yeah.
Why are you trying to milk a mule?
I don't know.
That's not an udder. That's a penis.
Yeah. What are you talking about, dude?
How drunk were you?
You went to third base.
I mean,
hey, this mule's only got one udder.
Hashtag mule two.
It's taking so long to get this milk out.
Really didn't have a good touch. I guess the mule didn't like it.
Dude, what is he drinking? Moonshine? He has to
Whoa,
be.
Dude. Come on, man. Come on. All right, I got one more submission here for a little kid or drunk adult. What is the dumb thing you did?
So I was sleeping at a friend's house. I was staying the night, and I have a tendency to sleepwalk. And I walk outside of his bedroom door, close it while sleepwalking, and proceed to pee on his door.
Okay. Anytime I know. Well, and when it's the sleepwalking, I've heard of with little kids, seen it. But I think typically when you're talking about peeing, there's so many adults I've seen that are drunk, and they get up and start peeing all over the place. So I'm guessing drunk adult on this. What do you think, Virginia?
I'm only talking about my personal life experience. I've seen it more with drunk adults, specifically guys I've dated.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Okay. What do you think, Bird?
Not Panda, though. Never.
Not Panda. No. Before Panda, this one guy, I woke up and he was peeing in the corner, and so I'm yelling at him to stop. And then a different time, he was in the bed peeing on me.
Oh,
and
my gosh.
I woke him up. I'm like, what are you doing? You're peeing on me. He goes, I'm not, but I'm about to. I'm like, what are you talking about? I'm wet. And he's fighting with me, and yeah, that didn't last.
That guy's an ex?
Do I know?
You do.
Okay, what are you thinking here, Bird? Is this a little kid or a drunk adult?
No, that one.
It's a drunk adult. I'm over here writing different names over to Virginia.
He's trying to guess who it is.
Guess, yeah. Drunk adult. Yeah.
Okay, drunk adult. That's what we're all thinking. What were you?
I was a drunk adult, yeah. And my friend didn't wake me up. He told me the next morning that I had slept, walked, and peed on his door.
Okay, yeah, that's typically what happens.
But you're right, because my buddy dated somebody. Anytime she would drink, every time she would pee the bed.
Because the bladder's full.
Wow. Every time.
You've been drinking so much, jeez. Your bladder is full. I mean, you got to release the pee.
Yeah.
Okay.
People found out. It was awful.
Oh. Yeah, it's pretty gnarly.
She did it on the couch, too. Oh. Well, people were out. Yeah, man.
Now you got to get a new couch.
You got to stop drinking. Or we got to get tape. Something.
Tape?
Cover it up.
Scotch tape?
Yeah,
I don't think it's going to work.
Fix the leak.
Sometimes all I think about is you. Late nights in the middle of June. E-Way's been faking me out. Can't make you happier now. Sometimes all I think about is you.
Usually I put something on TV, so we never think about you and me. But today I see our reflections clearly in Hollywood, laying on the screen.
You just need a better life than this. You need something I can never give. Fake water all across the road. It's gone, now the night is come. But
sometimes all I think about is you. Late nights in the middle of June. Been faking me out. Can't make you happier now.
You can't fight it. You can't breathe. You say something so loving, but now I gotta let you go. You'll be better off in someone new. I don't wanna be alone. You know it hurts me too. You look so broken when you cry. One more and then I say goodbye.
Sometimes all I think about is you. Late nights in the middle of June. Heat waves been faking me out. Can't make you happier now. Sometimes all I think about is you. Late nights in the middle of June. Heat waves been faking me out. Can't make you happier now.
I just wanna know what you're dreaming of. When you sleep and smile so comfortable, I just wish that I could give you that look that's perfectly unsaid. Sometimes all I think about is you. Late nights in the middle of June. He always been faking me out. He always been faking me out.
Sometimes all I think about is you. Late nights in the middle of June. Sometimes all I think about is you. Late nights in the middle of June.
cool concept that you can actually play music out of your toilet. That's what some of the tricked out bidets are doing. I'd seen that. That's one thing that Drake does a lot of times when he wants to get a gift for a good friend, like DJ Khaled. He buys him bidets.
Wow, what a friend.
I think they're each toilet's, what is it, was it like 2,000 or something like that?
Those Toto toilets are crazy expensive.
Really? Okay. It was at least 2,000. I can't remember what the price was.
How expensive are they?
I need a bidet on my throat.
Oh
my
yeah. Gosh.
It's a constant stream of water.
Boy, oh boy. Only 25 more minutes, guys.
Rough, huh?
That is rough.
Yeah, so what Drake decides to play on his, he goes with the old classic Tupac song, Hit 'Em Up. So I guess you're singing Hit 'Em Up. I guess that kind of works for a toilet, maybe.
Y'all know that song?
I don't think I do.
That is his diss track towards Biggie, and it
sing
is
it.
Awesome.
How does it go?
Oh, man, that's going to be tough to... Six shots couldn't stop me, and you, I took it and smiled. That's all I got right now.
I think I know what you're talking
yeah,
about.
Yeah, it's a... Take money, West Side. First off, blank you. I can't. There's too many words in it. I was about to start singing it, but there's a lot.
I was just starting to get into it.
I know. Yeah. First off,
you can sing it to us on the podcast.
And the click you claim, West Side when we ride. Yeah, that's all I got.
Okay,
I like it.
Well, they've been debating here what are the best toilet tunes, and somebody came up with a top hit list. What do you think about this? Pat Benatar makes it in at number 5. Heaven with your best shot. Why ain't you here with your best shot? Heaven with your best shot. Fire away. Okay, all right. That's kind of fun.
It's cute.
That's playing out of your toilet.
I get it. We're doing a little... Oh. You dropped a bomb on me. I bet that's on the list.
You could, yeah.
You should put
that on the list.
Boom, boom, pal.
Yeah. The only thing about that, you dropped a bomb on me. Man, that's an old song. You know, the Gap Band. You're going all the way back to like 1980.
Just put on TikTok. Let some kids say, oh my God, look at this song.
It's a brand new song.
It'll blow up.
I love it.
Get on a skateboard, make a drink, make a video.
It should make it. You dropped a bomb on me, baby. You dropped a bomb on me. The only thing I think of with that song now, somebody's getting pooped on.
It's a very poopy song.
I gotta tell you, it's like, I don't know this.
You can play some R. Kelly because we know he loves urination.
Okay. Yeah, I guess you could.
Look.
It's amazing he didn't have a song that was urination themed. Really kind of surprised. Somebody suggested doing a little Salt and Pepper. Can you imagine that you're trying to be all discreet and you're acting like you're not going into somebody's bathroom to take a poo and it detects when you are and it starts playing that loudly and everybody at the party can hear that you're in there taking a dump?
It's a great trick.
Gosh, that would be terrible. Another hot song kind of on the same theme, and it is hot.
When the pimp's in the crib, ma, drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. When the pigs try to get at you, park it like it's hot. Park it like it's hot. Park it like it's hot. And if a get an attitude, pop it like it's hot. Pop it like it's hot. Pop it like it's hot. I've got the
rollie on. And if you're looking for a toilet tune to play out of your bidet and you have got kids, this should work.
Let it go. Let it go. Can't hold it back anymore.
No, I can't.
Let it go, turn away and slam the door.
That does work pretty well. That's a good little toilet tune there for the kids.
It's not a repeat, it's a replay. The KVJ replay on 97.9 WRMF. From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
Storm Smart provides homeowners with storm catcher screens, the leading hurricane safety product on the market. Storm Smart screens block up to 95% of rain and wind. Call 833-60-SMART or go to stormsmart.com for your free consultation. Donald Trump traveling to court this morning in Fort Pierce, and that is causing rolling roadblocks on 95 northbound. The motorcade has cleared Palm Beach County, and you are starting to see the delays lessen up on 95 northbound from Forest Hill Boulevard up to PGA Boulevard, but north of that, you are still seeing fairly heavy delays all the way to Orange
Avenue. Give yourself plenty of extra time this morning if you are behind the motorcade. As for Palm Beach County on the Turnpike, you are under speed in both directions in the area of the West Palm Beach Service Plaza, and there's also a crash to watch for on Lantana Road. This one is at Haverhill Road. In Broward County, an accident has shut down Commercial Boulevard. This is eastbound between Woodlands Boulevard and Rock Island Road. Take McNabb as an alternate and look for delays on 95 northbound between Copens Road and Hillsborough Boulevard. That's traffic. I'm Suits for 97.9 WRMF.
The Jeep Celebration event is going on right now with exceptional offers on a wide selection of Jeep brand vehicles. If you're looking to supercharge your next adventure, look no further than America's best-selling plug-in hybrid, the Jeep Wrangler 4xe. Or choose the luxurious Grand Cherokee or Grand Cherokee 4xe. All celebrations must come to an end, so hurry and visit Jeep.com or your local Jeep brand dealer for great deals during the Jeep Celebration event. Based on 2022 CYQ4 sales, JD Power retail sales data, Jeep is a registered trademark.
Demand Dave! 844-411-1LAW. Demand Dave! For car accident or slip and fall. Need a personal injury lawyer? Come rest and come rest. 844-411-1LAW. DemandDave.com.
Every March, Jersey Mike's turns money from subs into charitable donations.
And March 27th is Jersey Mike's annual day of giving, where 100% of sales from every sub are given back to the community.
And to kick off all that giving, Peter gave me an apron. I'm honored.
Looking good, Danny. We've got subs to make, though.
Yeah, now I know why you gave me the apron.
Join us Wednesday, March 27th for Jersey Mike's Day of Giving. Be a sub above.
I never wanted to get glasses, tried to do contact lenses, and it was a nightmare for me. I couldn't get them in my eyeballs. Every day was just a pain and an aggravation I didn't need. I never thought a LASIK procedure was something I could afford. I never thought it'd be something I could tolerate either. I figured it'd hurt. It doesn't. A laser does all the work. Your vision gets blurry. It clears up. You go back to work the very next day. It was that simple. 90 seconds, all it took. And it wasn't a pain in the pocket either. A lot more affordable than you'd ever think. It is going to save you money over time, so it's a great investment. Plus, they offer up a payment plan with zero down, zero interest for up to 12 months. And if you drop my name, Kevin, from the KVJ Show, they'll take an additional $500 off at Panu Laser. So what are you waiting for? They have convenient locations all over Broward County, now in Palm Beach as well. And their Dr. Mutiella has performed over 100,000 of these LASIK procedures, so you're in the best hands possible. Book today at PanuLaser.com. That's PanuLaser.com.
Victim of a slip and fall? It takes one phone call to take back control of your life. Anajar and Levine will fight to get you the compensation you deserve. Call me, Mark Anajar, for a free consultation. 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
In office, West Palm Beach.
Hey, is your credit on life support? Take a deep breath. Listen up. Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach hosting a credit clinic at the dealership today and tomorrow. Yeah, it's Nick Rivers. Local bank representatives, they're going to be on site to grant special approval to consumers who meet certain minimum criteria. If you got a job bringing home $350 a week, the credit clinic at Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach, they want to approve you so you can drive home in your new Kia today. Yeah, Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach hosting a credit clinic at the dealership today and tomorrow. If you have a job bringing home $350 a week, the credit clinic wants to approve you for a new Kia. What are you waiting for? Don't miss the credit clinic today and tomorrow at Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach. Call 800-NEW-KIAS online, greenwaykiawestpalmbeach.com, and remember,
we want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
Credit affects down payment and approval terms.
Dunkin's, iced coffee with a French vanilla swirl, vanilla shot, sweet cold foam, and cinnamon sugar topping. America runs on Dunkin'. Price and participation may vary. Limited time offer.
Are you having a problem with your weight? So many people in life do, and sometimes you need a little extra help because dieting and exercise is not getting it done. Wellington Anti-Aging is in your corner, and even if you have had stubborn fat holding on for decades, you can get rid of it with the power of the pharmaceuticals offered at Wellington Anti-Aging. They can get that weight off of you to live a healthier life, and they can do other great things like balance out your hormones. That's very key. It does establish your metabolism, your energy levels, your libido, all these great things you can regulate. And it can also help you with any kind of symptoms from menopause, like hot flashes and night sweats. Plus, it can even fend off some long-term health complications like osteoporosis, heart disease, type 2 diabetes, even some forms of cancer. And they even do the cosmetic stuff like age spots, wrinkles. If you want to look better and feel better, just click on to WellingtonAntiAging.com. That's WellingtonAntiAging.com.
At Charmin, we heard you shouldn't talk about going to the bathroom in public, so we decided to sing about it.
When you roll the Charmin up your sock on the potty, let's just also roll it back, everybody. Charmin's irresistibly soft and hella nice. Our crib is always stocked.
It's our potty mind.
Charmin Ultra Soft is irresistibly soft and more absorbent, so you can use less. Enjoy the go with Charmin.
Strax Aesthetics unlocks the secret to great cosmetic surgery. Have surgery now and pay later. Breast augmentations and tummy tucks less than $150 per month for qualified patients. Extreme weight loss with a gastric sleeve procedure. The Strax Med Spa offers Botox for $9.99 per unit and unbeatable prices on Juvederm. Guaranteed to beat any comparable quote. Schedule a free face-to-face consultation with your actual board-certified surgeon. Saturday appointments available too. Visit StraxPlastics.com or call 954-749-3040 for more info.
Injured in an accident? Visit Lytle Ryder, Smith, Ivey, and Fronrath at foryourrights.com.
From the Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach Studio,
we want to see you in a Greenway Kia.
This is 97.9 WRMF Palm Beach.
When you went clubbing, where did you go? Do you remember your favorite clubs from back in the day, Virginia?
Oh, yeah. I used to hit Bourbon Street.
Okay.
As a young girl with a fake ID, I was skipping down Bourbon Street.
Yeah?
It was fun.
What was the name of the club that stands out to you?
I mean, we used to go to Bourbon Cowboy.
Okay.
We used to go to Johnny Mac's. We used to go to Maggie May's. We used to go to the Gold Mine. Oh, my gosh. The Gold Mine was so dirty. It was just...
The Gold Mine, the filthy spot.
It was scuzzy.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Bird, what about you? What was your favorite club from back in the day?
Only talking about flirts.
Okay.
Chase skirts at flirts.
You could take it to second base
flirts. People would hook up in flirts. That was where you go to get a little naughty. Well, you had a bunch of just people who are very young, just kind of learning how to drink, and then they're just getting in there and just... People would jump in the cage, and then things would happen in the cage. We're talking carnal things, Virginia.
Why everybody was watching?
Oh yeah, that's what made it exciting.
Let me see some of the top answers that we got. Bringing it down by city in West Palm Beach, Gemma said last weekend in Club Safari.
Club Safari. I can't tell you how many times me and my friends got kicked out of that place.
Okay. Heather, she would go hang out at Liquid. Do you remember that down on Clematis Street?
Yes, yeah. I do.
You remember Bar?
Yeah. And the other one.
I think it was on Olive in downtown West Palm for a little bit. Yeah, and then Dax off Clematis, she said.
It wasn't a club, but it was a bar, although there would be some dancing there. It was at Gatsby's off of Village. Man, that place used to be jumping.
Yeah. I always hear people talking about Christine's in Jupiter. Old school people always talk about Christine's.
Old school, I do know about Christine's.
Panda talks about it.
Oh, yeah. I used to run these waters. And these shores with a panda. I'm not sure what that meant.
What?
Kathy said respectable in Palm Beach back in the 90s was where I would go clubbing in the day.
It's still there, though.
Remember when E.R. Bradley's was on Palm Beach?
Yes.
It wasn't downtown. It was on Palm Beach Island. Because we would go there and dance on the bar and get kicked out.
That's right. You ever heard of the Bowery? Sounds familiar. Where was the Bowery? That's what Butch said. He said that was where he would go clubbing.
That's
back
in New
day.
York.
Oh, okay.
The Bowery's in New York City.
Aha. Uh-huh.
I brought up this place yesterday.
Limelight.
On the podcast, and no one knew what I was talking about. Banana Max in Jupiter. Does anybody remember that listening right now? Banana Max in
Jupiter.
I think
I heard of that.
Or am I making that up?
The Banana Boat?
No, Banana Max. The Max.
That does sound familiar, actually. I think I've heard that before.
But is that from Saved by the Bell? Am I getting sitcoms and...
The Peach Pit.
Yes.
Yeah.
I used to always party at the Peach Pit. Oh, wait a minute.
No, I didn't.
Yeah, I know.
I just watched the show.
I'm getting you confused.
That happens.
Nicole was hanging out at Club Boca and Boca Raton back in the day.
I remember Club Boca, and I remember the Bay Club. that was, I thought, down in Boca or down in Broward County, but it was jumping back in the 90s.
Yeah, a lot of the places in Lauderdale. Dara said Voodoo Lounge is where she was clubbing back in the day. Baja Beach Club is where Sheila was going. There was also Cafe Iguana.
Yes.
At Beach Place.
I remember that.
Okay.
Remember
that? Yeah. Banana Max used to be where Harborside is now.
I got it right.
My friend is texting me.
Boom. I just like when you just like when you're not crazy.
Banana Max. That's where people got busted for doing a bunch of cocaine.
Oh, Kevin.
Imagine that.
We're
huh?
talking 80s cocaine. The good
stuff. Imagine that.
The purest form.
Uh-huh. You see some other places. Debbie loved every place on the strip in Lauderdale. Confetti, La Bear, Baja Beach, Button South, Bogart's, Penrod's, Club 1235. Tressie was going to Reunion Room, Squeeze, and Rosebud's. Rachel loved the Edge in Lauderdale. Trish said Atlantis on Fort Lauderdale Beach. I think I remember that from back in the day. I think that's maybe they were tossing the napkins. Nicole said America's Backyard. That place is still thriving. She went to Automatic Slims is another spot she went to. Do you remember Passions, the nightclub at the old Hard Rock? That's where Mark used to hang out.
Passions,
yeah.
I remember the soap opera.
Okay, no, I went there one time. I remember that. Eve said Christopher's and September's in Fort Lauderdale is where she was clubbing back in the day. And then some of the old Miami clubs, it's still around. Nicole, she remembers going to Nikki Beach. Chelsea went to 90 Degrees. Freddie was at the Kitchen. Let me see. We got Nicole who would go to Glam Slam. And then Audra, Liv in Miami. Liv has been open forever.
Yeah, it has.
Like, when has it not been open?
People are saying Dr. Feelgood's.
Yeah, down in West Palm Beach on Clematis Street.
Now it's Pawn Shop.
Okay. Some of the other places. Charlotte went to Casablanca and Stewart. Sips in Port St. Lucie and Shuckers.
Oh, what was the one they used to always send me when we were at our old station? Wild Coyote. It was like 9 different bars within, I think, a 3-month span.
They kept changing the name of it.
It was a lot, yeah.
That
Wild
happens.
Coyote.
Got a shout out for Off the Hookah. That was downtown West Palm Beach for a long time. The Chili Pepper. That might have been Lauderdale. Yeah, a lot of good stuff. That we're getting there. Ibiza. Yeah, that was a big one as well.
Spanky's?
Where was Spanky's?
So Spanky's was, that was big on Clematis for the longest time, right by the train tracks. You know when you're down Clematis and the tracks cross over and you have to wait?
Okay.
It was right there.
Oh, yeah, I do remember that. Yeah.
Very popular.
I used to go there a lot. Yeah, now it's just like a dog park.
Yeah, then I thought they had another Spanky's in Jupiter.
Okay.
Back in the early 2000s.
I do remember that. Shout out for Casanova's in Hialeah, Brio Beach Club, and Club Moscow. A lot of people were saying that as well.
Club Moscow? Was that off North Lake Boulevard? And was that in Gardens or
Lake
Park?
A lot of people name dropped it.
I remember that place.
Club Moscow?
That was too young for me. My brother would go there.
Yeah.
If it's the right place, I'm thinking.
Okay. Cruzan Liquor Stand getting that shout out as well. So lots of cool places.
Everybody. because you just can't get enough KVJ. The KVJ Replay on 97.9 WRMS.
Hey, Florida, are you ready to meet Birch Lane? It's Megan, and I am so excited. The first ever Birch Lane stores are now open, where you can shop high-quality, classic furniture and decor in person. Don't miss the grand opening sales all month long. Plus, get expert help on home projects with free design services. It's classic style for joyful living. Shop Birch Lane, a Wayfair specialty brand at Meisner Park in Boca Raton and at birchlane.com.
We pay the max. We pay the max. We pay the max. Let AutoBuy pay you the max. You're on your way. Two big fat stacks. We pay the max. We pay the max. We pay the max.
Get the max for your pre-owned car, truck, or SUV. Go to wepaythemax.com.
Business. It's not a 9-to-5 proposition. It's all day and into the night. It's all the things that keep this world turning. And behind every one of these businesses is a partner like Comcast Business helping to keep it all moving. It's why the local flower shop and your favorite pizza joint, the startup in the stadium, hospitals and hotels, banks and restaurants nationwide, all these businesses choose the advanced network, cybersecurity solutions, and round-the-clock trusted partnership from Comcast Business. From Main Street to Wall Street, our people are powering the businesses that power it all. So when you're ready to unlock what's possible for your business, there's no one better to answer the call. Comcast Business, powering possibilities.
Restrictions apply. Call or visit ComcastBusiness.com to learn more.
Jaybird, oh, I love me some Dunkin', and I am hungry like a horse or a hippo. Dunkin's got deals galore. In fact, my dad got his wake-up wrap yesterday. He told me, hey, Bird, I'm at Dunkin', I'm getting my wake-up wrap. He loves them. There's so many great things at Dunkin' that I love as well. I love the hash browns. I love them stuffed bageled minis. Download their app, too. DD Perks membership's going to get you deals galore, my friends. I am Jaybird, and I run on Dunkin'.
You know that Big Bargain detergent jug is 80% water, right?
80% water? I thought I was getting a better deal because it's so big.
If you want a better clean, Tide Pods are only 12% water. The rest is pure, concentrated cleaning ingredients.
Ooh, pass me the intercom thingy.
Attention shoppers, if you want a real deal, try Tide Pods.
Don't pay for water, pay for clean. If it's gotta be clean, it's gotta be Tide Pods.
Water content based on the leading bargain liquid detergent.
On an MSC cruise, beauty is everywhere. It's in the thrill of a water slide, top-notch entertainment, and in quieter propellers. It's in the sunset and that toast on your very first night on board. Discover the beauty of Ocean Key, MSC's private island marine reserve, and more destinations with up to 40% off cruises, plus drinks, Wi-Fi, and more included. MSC Cruises, for a greater beauty. To book, visit msccruises.com or contact your travel advisor. Restrictions apply. Ships registered in Panama, Malta.
A nice start on this Thursday morning. Temperatures throughout the morning in the mid to upper 60s. Then we're going to warm up to those low 80s this afternoon with the high 83 degrees with a mix of clouds and sunshine. Little chance for rain. That continues again today. I'm WPTV First Alert meteorologist Jennifer Correa on 97.9 WRMF.
Sponsored by the Florida Department of Transportation. Hey, listeners, before celebrating St. Patrick's Day this year, remember to plan ahead and know all your options. If you drink, don't get behind the wheel. Instead, designate a sober driver or catch a ride service. And if you are the designated sober driver, commit to staying sober. Don't let your luck run out.
Now, back to more of the KVJ Replay. Only on 97.9 WRMF.
At any age, I find all these things to be really good pieces of advice. So if you're young, good news, you're going to get these now. If you're older, it's kind of a checklist to say, okay, am I doing this? What advice would you give to your younger self? But everything in this is a really solid nugget.
Don't go to business school, Bird. None of the credits are going to transfer and you're going to end up just kind of peeing that money away.
Bird's got his own list. Number one on the list, be more confident. Confidence is very important. You accomplish more things when you are confident. Believe in yourself.
But that's easier said than done.
It is.
What does someone have to do to apply that and really make that work in their life?
I think the reason why we do it better as we get older is we gain a little bit more confidence in ourselves because we're a little bit more self-aware. We start to understand our strengths and our weaknesses, and we realize that everybody has them. And you're not going to be good at absolutely everything, but if you can figure out what it is you are good at, carry some confidence around, because I believe every person was given their own set of gifts and skills that they can do, and you can do something uniquely better than about anybody else on planet Earth.
And it's not something you can just pluck off a tree sometimes. You have to work at that stuff for some people, you know?
I think that's why it's typically a trait you see later on in life, because it does take a lot of trial and error to get yourself there.
But there's good and bad. Like you said, there's qualities within you that are good, and there's qualities in you that you wish that you didn't, you know, have. Focus on those good ones and develop those good ones, and maybe don't, you know, beat yourself up about the bad ones.
Well, I think you gotta be self-aware too, knowing the hand you've been dealt with and then using it at the best of your ability and really making it work for you.
Another piece of advice, try not to care what other people think, and that's another easier said than done, but the one thing I would at least tell you to try doing is look at the people that don't really matter in your life, and why would you care? People on social media, people that you don't like anyway, people that you know are nasty and are there to cut you down. If you can start with them and saying, I should not care at all what they think.
Yeah, if they're yucky and you wouldn't even go out to dinner with them, what do you care if their opinion of you is?
It is a good lesson to learn as a kid, almost kind of like flossing your teeth. You just know it's the way of the world.
Right.
You got to floss your teeth, if not your teeth fall out. When you go out into the world, you know there's going to be cavity people. You know what I mean? They're going to gnaw you.
Mm-hmm. Don't let opportunities pass you by. That's really, to me, a lot of what life is. And you think about where you are, whatever you've done, if you're a little bit older and you consider yourself to be successful, there is likely an opportunity that came your way that you did not pass up, that you took advantage of. And that's why you are where you are. And so that's a lesson to a younger you, is don't let those opportunities pass you by thinking that the world is going to be full of them. Because sometimes, as Eminem says, you only get one shot.
Damn.
Mm-hmm.
Mom spaghetti.
Look after your physical health. Don't wait till it's too late in life.
When is it too late, Virginia? Can you reverse this thing?
You can, but they said it's easier to start good habits when you're younger than if you get to be 40 or 50 years old and all of a sudden you're like, well, I'm going to get healthy. And then it's just really hard because you ever heard that old dog, new tricks? Kind of hard to turn it around. What other advice would you give to your younger self? Don't waste time with negative people. Very true. Be mindful. Does somebody always have negative things to say about somebody? It's not necessarily somebody you need to be spending your time with. Learn from your mistakes so you don't repeat them.
Protect your skin. You live in South Florida. Put something on to protect it. Take it from Crowfish Carla over here. I'm telling you.
Crowfish.
What are they called? Crowfish. Crowfeet. Yeah. Your boy's off today.
Yeah.
I went to bed at 1:15.
Oh, boy. Save 10% of your paycheck. The earlier you start, the better off you'll be.
Yeah, there's that list where you Google it, you type in your age, and it's supposed to say, this is how much money you're supposed to have in your savings. If not, you're doing it all wrong.
Always makes you feel terrible
it's
by yourself.
Worst. Yeah. Don't Google it, y'all.
Yeah. Other things, go on all the vacations you can. Don't get so focused on work that you skip them.
If you like vacations, some people don't like to travel and go out and do stuff. Your point, I think when you have time off, do things that almost like a vacation for your soul.
Yeah, I think a vacation doesn't always mean traveling. I think a vacation is just taking some time for yourself to do what you want to do, things that are positive, that kind of reset yourself.
Things that give you a little joy and happiness.
Mm-hmm.
Do it.
Absolutely. Also, advice you would give to your younger self, don't settle. That applies to work, relationships, and everything else. How many the makeup or breakup emails do we have that just have that tone of, I'm settling? And it's like, girl, boy, whatever, walk away. You're in a bad situation.
I don't think I've ever told you that it's a makeup.
Yeah. And there's good reason, because there's a lot of people that are settling and they're staying in bad relationships.
And then 10 years from now, you're going to go, why did I waste the best years of my life?
Yeah, and I know someone who's going through that. They feel like they have completely married the wrong person, wasted a third of their life.
Well, it's not too late. You're never going to be this young. You're never going to be this cute. As you are right now, it's never too late to get out there again.
Mm-hmm. They're married. It's over.
Well, not really. They can get a divorce. If your spouse is making you miserable, you need to realize that that is a toxic situation and do better. Feel better about yourself.
Other advice to give to your younger self, collect memories and not material things. Okay.
Can we have both?
What if the memories you make are all about getting material possessions?
All my memories are about cute shoes and purses.
When Daddy took me shopping.
I remember that time so well. Relax and enjoy the ride.
That's a good one. Mm-hmm. I feel like a lot of times we don't. That was my biggest knock playing baseball my entire life. I loved baseball so much, but I didn't enjoy it like I should have. I put way too much pressure. It became this anxiety thing where I tried too hard. I didn't enjoy it, especially towards the back end of it. It wasn't fun. And I look back now wishing, going, man, I should have enjoyed it more. Mm-hmm. Playing ball with your friends, sunshine, smell of popcorn, Virginia.
Spend more time with your parents while you still can. Celebrate the little wins in life, not just the big ones.
I love that. Today, let's find some little win within our show today. Let's celebrate the hell out of it.
Love it.
It could even be breakfast.
Another piece of advice, look after your mental health.
So there
you go. Yeah.
And eliminate people that try to snatch your healthy mental health. Just don't give them your time.
Now that she's back in the atmosphere with drops of Jupiter in her head, she acts like summer and walks like rain. Reminds me that there's a time to change. Since the return of her stay on the moon, she listens like spring and she talks like June. Hey, 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 hey. Well, tell me, did you sail across the sun? Did you make it to the Milky Way to see the lights all fading and that heaven is overrated? Well, tell me, did you fall from a shooting star? While you were looking for yourself out there.
for a round of Hick Picks. These are rhyming riddles, and the answer to the riddle is going to be a pair of words that rhyme with each other. Virginia versus Jaber in a head-to-head battle. You're going to get 10 seconds to try to come up with the correct answer. Go on ahead, Bert. I believe you can put on the Hick Pink robe, correct, because you are the champ?
I'm the champ?
Yeah.
Oh, no, Virginia might be the champ.
Yeah, I think Virginia's the champ.
Well, I never got the robe when I got crowned champion last week. Somebody who won the prior week took it home and lost the robe.
I think this is all alleged, and there's still an investigation going on.
Well, where's the robe?
I couldn't find the robe, but I do have this bottle of Tahitian treat. It's all I could find. That was the closest thing to being pink in the back room.
We had that gorgeous robe that said Hick Pink on it.
KVJ Nation made that for us.
It's probably at my... If I'm the champ, it's got to be at my house then.
It was customized.
Oh, you don't care. You don't care about any of these trophies or gowns.
Whatever. I wore the no-name movie game belt.
And you didn't get
belt.
To wear it at all this week.
I didn't get to wear it one day.
Oh, my gosh.
I plan on stinking up the camera tonight.
I wish you guys really did care about the Hick Pink robe and the No Name Movie Game belt. But you guys only like it because it puts a spotlight on me and being a jackass.
It's the only time we want to talk about it.
It's the only time.
When you lose it, now I'm in.
That's exactly the only time you guys like it.
Okay, one for practice so people understand what a Hick Pink is. If I say pheasant prison, you say
rat. No.
What? What? No. Rat? Did you say rat?
It's not going to go well for him today.
Oh, man. I have a feeling he's not going to win.
Quail jail.
Quail jail is what we'd be looking for, Virginia. Rat.
I meant to say rats. I'm not very good at this game. All right, get focused.
Okay.
Get focused.
Let's go.
Yeah,
it's a big day today.
Big day.
Okay, you got 10 seconds on the clock. Tell me what the Hick Pink would be. If you have a situation where you turn a clenched hand, what have you done? You turn your clenched hand. Two words that rhyme with each other.
Twist fist.
Twist fist.
Oh.
Is what you did.
Bird, wake up. Here we go.
Oh, I love the twist fist. When you hit somebody, just twist.
Yeah.
Grind it in there real good.
Right on their face.
Yeah. If you're wearing jewelry, it's even better.
You are very violent today.
She really is, yeah.
You
kind of scary.
You need a nap.
Yeah.
I do.
Yeah.
Really think you do.
Yeah. Right. Yeah.
Nope. No sleep.
It's horrifying.
Okay, what about this? Tight fitting coffee mug. Tight fitting coffee mug. I may be giving you one of the words right there, too.
Tug mug!
Tug?
Snug mug.
Snug!
Oh, Virginia at the buzzer! Snug mug.
Snug mug.
That was a weak one.
Whatever. If you would have got the point, you'd be like, yeah, it was great, Kevin.
Tied at one apiece here. Could this do it right here?
Oh, we're only doing three today?
Well, we'll see here.
Well, you took so long not being able to find the robe. You killed all that time.
The nerve about prolonging a bit. The nerve.
Right.
Prolong Sinicky.
I have a list of 12.
Foot covering cube would be a what? A foot covering.
Sock. Flock. Sock.
Cube.
Sock.
Foot covering cube.
This is Hard Rock. No.
Socks. Box.
Oh. Pluralized.
Sock box. Socks box. Got it.
Okay.
All right.
All right, what about
that
this?
That one's on us.
Okay.
Foot, you know, I think it's singular. All right.
What is a prying Boy Scout group?
Noisy Boise. Noisy Boise.
No.
Snoop Troop.
Snoop Troop. Virginia has it. And a win.
No!
Oh!
No!
You can go ahead and put the robe on me. Homie, where's the robe?
Oh, evil wins again.
Yes.
I said, are you serious? I try, but I can't figure out. I've been next to you all night. I still don't know what you're about. You keep talking, but not much coming out your mouth. Can't you tell that I want you? I say, yeah. I'll be your help. Just know me, yeah. So sure of yourself.
still half your age. Yeah, you look, 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 looking at me like on some sweet escape. Obvious that you want me, but I said, I will want myself. Let me please believe it. I'll play you through hell. Just ignore me, yeah, yeah. So sure of yourself. Baby, don't get greedy. That I want as well. Ooh, and well. He said, I'm just curious. Is this for real? Just and I can't tell if you love or hate me. Never met someone.
KVJ Replay on 97.9 WRMF.
You know, so many of us as we age find that our hair is thinning, breaking, balding. It's normal, but you can do something about it. You don't have to have limp, lifeless, patchy hair. You can do what I'm doing. Go to Scalp Elite of West Palm Beach and let them show you their transdermal infusion of advanced PRP that is helping people regrow hair. Yeah, even alopecia patients, patients that are balding, patients that are thinning, patients that just have noticed all the thickness diminish, they can bring it back at Scalp Elite of West Palm Beach. Go see Roberto and the team. They are amazing. They also do scalp micropigmentation, which is little tiny dots that make it look more full. I love that. Scalp Elite of West Palm Beach, 561-318-7284.
Want more speed? Then you're in luck, because Xfinity just increased their internet speeds, and they're faster than ever. Plus, with super fast internet and a reliable connection, you can do more of what you love whenever you want. More gaming, more downloading, more video chatting, and more cozy nights on the couch streaming your favorite movies and TV shows. If life with double the speed is sounding pretty awesome, that's because it is. It's time to get more out of your internet with faster speeds from Xfinity. Get 150 megabit Xfinity internet for only $20 a month for 12 months with no annual contract. That's double the speed for the same great price. Plus, for a limited time, learn how you can get a $100 prepaid card when you get more speed when you sign up online. Just go to Xfinity.com to switch today. Requires paperless billing and autopay with stored bank account. Restrictions apply. Equipment taxes and other charges extra. After promo, regular rates apply. Actual speeds vary and not guaranteed.
Hello, Saver. Whether you're saving for that trip to the tropics or saving for an emergency, now is the time to take advantage of Wells Fargo's savings options. Wells Fargo offers savings accounts that can help you save towards your goals. So, what are you saving for? Visit a Wells Fargo branch or wellsfargo.com/save to open a savings account today.
Wells Fargo Bank N.A. Member FDIC.
Every March, Jersey Mike's turns money from subs into charitable donations.
And March 27th is Jersey Mike's annual day of giving, where 100% of sales from every sub are given back to the community.
And to kick off all that giving, Peter gave me an apron. I'm honored.
Looking good, Danny. We've got subs to make, though.
Yeah, now I know why you gave me the apron.
Join us Wednesday, March 27th for Jersey Mike's Day of Giving. Be a sub above.
Hey, honey, I have a great idea for summer vacation. Let's go to Chicago. We can take the kids to the aquarium, the Navy Pier, and maybe even a baseball game. We can eat deep dish pizzas and Chicago-style hot dogs.
That's a great idea, and the kids will love it, but only if we fly from PBI.
Chicago, here we come.
Let's book our flight today.
Already on it.
Palm Beach International Airport, South Florida's award-winning and favorite airport. Now flying direct to Chicago. Visit PBIA.org for more info.
Rapids Water Park. Mega Thrills. Mega Fun. And coming later this spring, new Mega Mayhem. The first dueling water coaster in Florida. Visit now for spring break and come back for Mega Mayhem with a season pass. Save 45% and get a free souvenir cup now through April 3rd. Only at South Florida's Mega Thrill Capital, Rapids Water Park. It's Mega 2024.
The Jeep Celebration event is going on right now with exceptional offers on a wide selection of Jeep brand vehicles. If you're looking to supercharge your next adventure, look no further than America's best-selling plug-in hybrid, the Jeep Wrangler 4xe. Or choose the luxurious Grand Cherokee or Grand Cherokee 4xe. All celebrations must come to an end, so hurry and visit Jeep.com or your local Jeep brand dealer for great deals during the Jeep Celebration event. Based on 2022 CYQ4 sales, J.D. Power retail sales data, Jeep is a registered trademark.
Psst, have you heard the news about Stringer's Tavern and Oyster Bar? Look, brace yourself because they've upped their game and launched a brand new menu. Yeah, my mouth is watering just thinking about their she crab bisque and luscious sterling silver Kansas City strip steak. Oh, not to mention, of course, you know, their oysters. Plus, they've got your next event covered with their new private room that seats 70 people. Check out stringerstavern.com for weekly events, live music, reservations, and more. Stringer's Tavern and Oyster Bar in Sewell's Point for a guaranteed good time. Hey, could I get another one of these?
Injured? Visit Lytle Rider Smith, Ivy, and Fromrath at foryourrights.com.
The KVJ replay continues right now, only on 97.9 WRMF.
Some things just to see you come running, running, and say the one thing I've been wanting, but no.
At any age, I find all these things to be really good pieces of advice. So if you're young, good news, you're going to get these now. If you're older, it's kind of a checklist to say, okay, am I doing this? What advice would you give to your younger self? But everything in this is a really solid nugget.
Don't go to business school, Bird. None of the credits are going to transfer and you're going to end up just kind of peeing that money away.
Bird's got his own list. Number one on the list, be more confident. Confidence is very important. You accomplish more things when you are confident. Believe in yourself.
But that's easier said than done.
It is.
What does someone have to do to apply that and really make that work in their life?
I think the reason why we do it better as we get older is we gain a little bit more confidence in ourselves because we're a little bit more self-aware. We start to understand our strengths and our weaknesses, and we realize that everybody has them. And you're not going to be good at absolutely everything, but if you can figure out what it is you are good at, carry some confidence around, because I believe every person was given their own set of gifts and skills that they can do, and you can do something uniquely better than about anybody else on planet Earth.
And it's not something you can just pluck off a tree sometimes. You have to work at that stuff for some people, you know?
I think that's why it's typically a trait you see later on in life, because it does take a lot of trial and error to get yourself there.
But there's good and bad. Like you said, there's qualities within you that are good, and there's qualities in you that you wish that you didn't, you know, have. Focus on those good ones and develop those good ones, and maybe don't, you know, beat yourself up about the bad ones.
Well, I think you gotta be self-aware too, knowing the hand you've been dealt with, and then using it at the best of your ability and really making it work for you.
Another piece of advice, try not to care what other people think, and that's another easier said than done, but the one thing I would at least tell you to try doing is look at the people that don't really matter in your life, and why would you care? People on social media, people that you don't like anyway, people that you know are nasty and are there to cut you down. If you can start with them and saying, I should not care at all what they think.
Yeah, if they're yucky and you wouldn't even go out to dinner with them, what do you care if their opinion of you is?
It is a good lesson to learn as a kid, almost kind of like flossing your teeth. You just know it's the way of the world.
Right.
You got to floss your teeth, if not your teeth fall out. When you go out into the world, you know there's going to be cavity people. You know what I mean? They're going to gnaw you.
Mm-hmm. Don't let opportunities pass you by. That's really, to me, a lot of what life is. And you think about where you are, whatever you've done, if you're a little bit older and you consider yourself to be successful, there's likely an opportunity that came your way that you did not pass up, that you took advantage of. And that's why you are where you are. And so that's a lesson to a younger you, is don't let those opportunities pass you by thinking that the world is going to be full of them. Because sometimes, as Eminem says, you only get one shot.
Damn.
Mm-hmm.
Mom spaghetti.
Look after your physical health. Don't wait till it's too late in life.
When is it too late, Virginia? Can you reverse this thing?
You can, but they said it's easier to start good habits when you're younger than if you get to be 40 or 50 years old and all of a sudden you're like, well, I'm going to get healthy. And then it's just really hard because you ever heard that old dog, new tricks? Kind of hard to turn it around. What other advice would you give to your younger self? Don't waste time with negative people. Very true. Be mindful. Does somebody always have negative things to say about somebody? It's not necessarily somebody you need to be spending your time with. Learn from your mistakes so you don't repeat them.
Protect your skin. You live in South Florida. Put something on to protect it. Take it from Crowfish Carla over here. I'm telling you.
Crowfish.
What are they called? Crowfish. Crowfeet. Your boy's off today.
Yeah.
I went to bed at 1:15.
Oh, boy. Save 10% of your paycheck. The earlier you start, the better off you'll be.
Yeah, there's that list where you Google it. You type in your age, and it's supposed to say, this is how much money you're supposed to have in your savings. If not, you're doing it all wrong.
Always makes you feel terrible
it's
by yourself.
Worst. Yeah. Don't Google it, y'all.
Yeah. Other things, go on all the vacations you can. Don't get so focused on work that you skip them.
If you like vacations, some people don't like to travel and go out and do stuff. To your point, I think when you have time off, do things that almost like a vacation for your soul.
Yeah, I think a vacation doesn't always mean traveling. I think a vacation is just taking some time for yourself to do what you want to do, things that are positive, that kind of reset yourself.
Things that give you a little joy and happiness.
Mm-hmm.
Do it.
Absolutely. Also, advice you would give to your younger self, don't settle. That applies to work, relationships, and everything else. How many the makeup or breakup emails do we have that just have that tone of, I'm settling? And it's like, girl, boy, whatever, walk away. You're in a bad situation.
I don't think I've ever told you that it's a makeup.
Yeah. And there's good reason, because there's a lot of people that are settling and they're staying in bad relationships.
And then 10 years from now, you're going to go, why did I waste the best years of my life?
Yep. Man, I know someone who's going through that. They feel like they have completely married the wrong person.
Tough.
Wasted a third of their life. They
Well, it's not too late. You're never going to be this young. You're never going to be this cute as you are right now. It's never too late to get out there again.
Mm-hmm.
They're married. It's over.
Well, not really. They can get a divorce. If your spouse is making you miserable, you need to realize that that is a toxic situation and do better. Feel better about yourself.
Other advice to give to your younger self, collect memories and not material things. Okay.
Can we have both?
What if the memories you make are all about getting material possessions?
All my memories are about cute shoes and purses.
When Daddy took me shopping.
I remember that time so well. Relax and enjoy the ride.
That's a good one. Mm-hmm. I feel like a lot of times we don't. That was my biggest knock playing baseball my entire life. I loved baseball so much, but I didn't enjoy it like I should have. I put way too much pressure. It became this anxiety thing where I tried too hard. I didn't enjoy it, especially towards the back end of it. It wasn't fun. And I look back now wishing, going, man, I should have enjoyed it more. Mm-hmm. Playing ball with your friends, sunshine, smell of popcorn, Virginia.
Spend more time with your parents while you still can. Celebrate the little wins in life, not just the big ones.
I love that. Today, let's find some little win within our show today. Let's celebrate the hell out of it.
I love it.
It can even be breakfast.
Another piece of advice, look after your mental health.
So there
you go. Yeah.
And eliminate people that try to snatch your healthy mental health. Just don't give them your time.
Mm-hmm.
The KVJ Show on 97.9 WRMF.
Hi, it's Randy for Sono Bello, and I find that spring can be a little challenging. You know, it's warmer weather, you're getting outside, you're moving around, you're feeling great because the weather's warmer, and then you go to the closet, and maybe the clothes that fit last year don't fit this year. Well, Sono Bello springs you in a springtime shape.